Hello, everyone. How's it going? Sorry for being late. Yeah, I don't know why it stops at zero anymore. Hi, everyone. How's it going? What's going on? Yeah, Fruit Loops. Hello, old man, Mr. Bat. Hello, Brig and Sig. Hey, Egg Roll. What's going on, Venom? Hey, Xerix. Hello, Egg Roll Buddy. Hello, Over Emotional Robot. La Panda Face, what's going on? I think that's everyone. How's everyone doing tonight? So please be sure. So, what you might not know, and what you can't hear right now, this is kind of loud for me, so I'm going to flip that in a moment. But what you might not know, some behind the scenes baseball here, is I moved to a new streaming setup. Not hardware wise, but when it comes to software. So you might notice a higher quality stream, like literally, like I believe that this one's outputting at 1080p, 60 frames per second. However, I haven't tested any of it. Plus, the last time I streamed at 1080p, 60 frames, my internet, which is supposed to be very, very good, couldn't deal. So, I guess we're gonna see what happens. Right, they weren't being shown in the best light, but now, well, they're kind of blurry right now, honestly, to be totally honest with you, but I think that's the lighting at the moment. I am happy, Venom. I'm doing great. So far this stream is not breaking, which is good to know so far. Chat needs more nugs. It's true, right? Send out the nugs. Gosh, I hope you're all really excited. Oh gosh, you can see I got mascara on my eyelid. Way to start stream, Pando. Anyway, there's some nugs. Good things will happen tonight. It's very true. So we're going to be playing. Hello, Gurf. How's it going tonight? So we're going to be playing Final Fantasy VI. Has some heads up here. This will be my second-ish or third time starting. No, this will be my third time starting Final Fantasy VI from the beginning. So I've played this game. Oh, no worries over emotional robot. Be safe, and we'll see you soon. Yes, this time I'm gonna play through the end of Final Fantasy VI. I'm gonna see it. It's gonna be a huge deal. Kick clown, but yeah, down with Kefka, down with Kefka, right? That's what we shout and exclaim around here, right? The farthest I've got through is the last time I played, which was on my Game Boy Advance. So I own this game in multiple iterations. I own it on in the Final Fantasy Anthology for the PlayStation 1. I have it on my Game Boy Advance, which is the one I got the furthest in. And I have it on the Super Nintendo Classic or the SNES Classic or the, right, yes, the version I'm playing is the original version. I'm playing on my Super Nintendo Classic because it oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. I probably hit the webcam there. That was probably really annoying. So not the webcam, the mic. Okay, Xerix guide adjusted. Perfect. Yes, so I have played the Game Boy Advance version up to the part, the furthest I've gotten to was the part where, what happened? Right, Terra went Koopo for Koopo Nuts, and she like went, like, she was like a big glowy flying lady and flew all around, and then she kind of like crash landed somewhere, if I'm remembering that correctly, and we got to her. And we like kind of reconnected, and we were back together with Terra, and then nothing. What did I have for dinner? I actually last night I made I had leftovers from last night, and last night I made a beef and bell sprout stir fry. So that's what I had, and it was very, very good. A quarter in? Okay. Very interesting. I'm very excited. I have seen like the octopus guy who I can never remember his name. I've seen the opera. I've met Celis. I've done all that kind of stuff. So all that stuff is very like, I loved it. Beef and did I say Bellsprout? I might have said beef and bell pepper stir fry. Beef and bell peppers is what I had. Oh, well, this one I got. So I, like I told you, I actually use a website called I don't want this here. Sorry, excuse me. I went to a website. I usually go for this particular recipe. I like to try to my hand at Japanese cooking from time to time. So I use One Cookbook. That's the website called One Cookbook, like One Cookbook, One Cookbook. So that's what I use to learn how to make some interesting Japanese dishes, Brigansig. I try to do like Japanese home cooking on occasion, just to give it a shot, feel it out, see what it looks like. Hello, curly dude. How you doing tonight? The Uno cookbook. We're doing great. Thank you for asking. So yes, we're currently playing on my Super Nintendo Classic. I was considering playing Final Fantasy VI on my Game Boy Advance because I do have the ability to stream that. But I don't know. I wanted to see it. I didn't want to see this like in the squished down Game Boy Advance screen blown up. I kind of want to see the original version, you know what I'm saying? So I'm here for it. So we all know this game is Final Fantasy VI, but we'll see it referred to as Final Fantasy III throughout because we're playing that original North American version, but on the Super Nintendo Classic. So still will be probably the highest quality graphical look we can get from it. Curly dude, I'm doing really great. How are you doing? What's going on? What's on the up and up? I hope that you're all really excited to take this adventure, this great and grand premiere into season 12. I'm excited about it. You're excited about it. I think we're all excited about it, right? Okay, so I got a hydrate from Kaneki actually at the very beginning, so I'm just gonna do that. Ding! Thank you, thank you. Okay, your day could have been better, curly dude, but you're about to sleep soon, so it's all good. You're glad you managed to plug into the stream. Me too. Boba are not real. They are a lie. What on earth are you talking about, Venom? Boba is real. I think bubble tea might actually be the more common term, and it's like a Californian thing to call it boba. But I don't know. I think boba is a cute word to call bubble tea, so I added it as the name. Boba are real. Boba are real. It's true. Prove it. Yeah, Boba Fett does have his own tea, actually. It's really sweet and delicious. I don't know. It's really crazy, right? Okay, so before we start, I know Pando's always. I have just a tea a steeping over here, and I want to drink that tea while we're playing this game. As you can see, I'm definitely like a super cash, relaxed Pando tonight. I've got my big squishy hoodie on, my Fruit Loops t-shirt, and I'm just like. I'm ready to just slug it up and drink some tea and play some Final Fantasy VI with you all tonight. So, did y'all have really good weekends? Yeah, this slug, look at him go. Okay, tell me about your weekends. I'm just gonna go grab my tea and I'll be back in two shakes of a Pika's tail. Hello, Jophis. How are you doing? I got boba. Hello. So I got my tea here, my little tea-a-rooney. The pan break your weekend was so good you can't even remember it. Very nice. This is my I forget what it's called. It's like a caffeine puree though, or coffee puree, puree. I think I was told how to say it last time. Venom, this weekend's a super amazing streamer did a Saturday stream. Hey, that's me. The best Paper Mario and also did some Final Fantasy 14 content with the community. That was fun. Also, you did laundry and played with kids. That pretty much sums it up. That's awesome. That sounds like an A-okay kind of weekend. Of course, Jump Lust. Enjoy your walk. I'm really excited about Final Fantasy 6 too, let me tell you what. Okay, let's flip over to the video game then, shall we, and make sure everything continues to work. Also, you'll all have to tell me how loud it all is. So okay, this is not the game, obviously. This is the you can see we're playing on the SNES Classic here. And that's how 20 people went deaf. So you could hear the menu screen here has like some music, so tell me if it sounds it's not. It is. Oh, I guess it does say there's two, it's two player, huh? Isn't that wild? Yes, I do, Venom. I do have a SNES Classic. Final Fantasy 9 is two. Final Fantasy 6 is two player. Yeah, the minis. And Venom, I heard that you got me a. Oh, you did buy me a boba. Oh, that's so fun. Thank you, thank you. I didn't get my usual alert for that, so that's really fun. Thank you so much for the treat. Okay, jumping in here. Here we go, everyone. Premiere of Final Fantasy VI. You don't want to hear about ramen anymore? What's wrong with ramen? read the note. It wasn't you. I think it says. Okay, let's see here. It says that it was Venom 65656, so kind of like Final Fantasy IV, you could split the party up and have a second person control characters in battle. Oh, that's so fun. Oh yeah, Jophis, how are you doing today? It's so great to see you. Have a great night, Mog. Rest well. It might be on your end, but occasionally there's an audio hiccup, and very rarely a video one. Okay, that's good to know. I haven't. How are you doing, by the way, Captain Giraffe? It is now a 1080p video, so. What an epic beginning this game has, though, right? End of Realm Reborn was very, very cool and exciting, Mog. Yeah, I don't think they would have the patience, Venom. This is definitely not their kind of game. You haven't noticed any hiccups so far on your end? Well, that's good, LaPanda Face. Maybe it's that nationwide Rogers outage today. Hey, folks. Hey, my fellow Canadians. Thanks, Mog. Long ago, the War of the Magi reduced the world to a scorched wasteland, and magic simply ceased to exist. 1,000 years have passed. Iron, gunpowder, and steam engines have been rediscovered, and high technology reigns. Thanks for the lurk, Jophus. But there are some who would enslave the world by reviving the dread destructive force known as magic. Can it be that those in power are on the verge of repeating a senseless and deadly mistake? Oh no, your sewer line routered out today. Curly Dean, I'm sorry that you had a bad experience today. There's the town. Vix, is this changed in a different translation to be both Biggs and Wedge? Hard to believe an Esper's been found intact there, 1,000 years after the War of the Magi. Think he's still alive? Probably, judging from the urgency of our orders. And this woman, this sorcerer, why is she here? I heard she fried 50 of our Magitek armored soldiers in under 3 minutes. Not to worry. The slave crown on her head robs her of all conscious thought. She'll follow orders. It's Biggs later? Okay. We'll approach from the east. Move out. Yeah, I figured they would change that to the Biggs and Wedge. Well, I'll... In personal good news, you're able to schedule a COVID shot tomorrow morning. Someone must have canceled last minute because everywhere you're with the appointments are available 6 hours away. Oh, well, Zerix, as a Final Fantasy fan, this song's absolutely super familiar to me as well. And as someone who's played the game before, for sure. But, yeah, this song is just so good. I can imagine... So, this game is, like, you know, from 1994, this is, like, this would feel like such a cinematic experience at that time. I would have lost my brains if this was, like, the first kind of these games I ever played. Right, Gurf? Right, Zerix, it's totally true. Just, yes, my Magitek armor mount. I love hearing this every time I'm on my little, oh, gotta keep this thing active, I guess. But yeah, it looks so cool. It looks so cool to me even now, you know? Yeah, this music's so good. Yeah, that Mode 7 life, right? We're gonna see a lot of that good Mode 7 on the, we get the airship on the world map eventually, I believe. Really, Zerix? Right, Whamburger? It's got such a good... It's just, it's so artistic. They did so much with so little, you know? I think that's why I really appreciate these older games. No, Venom, I didn't think I've seen that. Okay, we did it. I wish... Oh, why is it... Let me play! Number 3 was number 3, Brigand Sig. Why is it... Why... Why can't I press start? I think this controller works. They finally did release 3 in North America for sure, Brig and Sig. Oh, I just need to mash through it? Okay, well. Some people still like me. Didn't we just do this all though? Did I accidentally press a button? No, press start or select. Yeah. that's my first. Oh, okay. Have a great night, curly dude. Rest well. Take it easy. Right. Oh, okay, okay, I understand. Okay, okay. I just never got a start screen at all. rest well and be safe, curly dude. Can someone throw a shout out to curly dude in chat, by the way? Venom, we do have to bring you back to Mordona. Though I am excited to see all the stuff that Heaven's Ward has to offer me. always do the shout out, Curly. You deserve it. Oh, look at the double shout out. So Brig and Sig, they released Final Fantasy III out in North America. They released it on the DS, on the Nintendo DS. So it was just called Final Fantasy III. And ever since Final Fantasy VI has been called Final Fantasy VI in North America. There's no one questions what Final Fantasy VI anymore is, right? It's just Final Fantasy VI is Final Fantasy VI. You just say, or as previously known as III. You know what I'm saying? So we get to watch this twice. That's very fun, but it's okay. It's a nice, relaxing start to this grand adventure, I feel. This is a cinematic, Pando. Figure it out. Okay. Well, here we are. Drinking my tea. Right, Xerix? I would like a radio on my Magitek mount, please. My boba's here. A coolie jammer and a brownie. Brig, sometimes I know that you're like 88, but also, oh yeah, here we go. We're in it. I have to pick up something from the door. Be back in 2 shakes of a pika's tail. Thank you. I'm back, and I got bubbly tea. What up? Check that out. See? It is a blueberry bubbly tea. Drop the pikas. Do-do-do-do-do. Sorry, the elevator was really slow, so... Okay, ready for the best part? This is the best part. Yeah, stab it. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm-mm. Ding. Delicious. Thank you so much, Venom, or whoever Venom claims got the bubble tea. I really appreciate it. What a tasty treat. I wonder if we'll get little blueberry seeds in my teeth all time. So I accidentally pressed the A button where they said, let's make the girl take point. There was a note? I didn't see any notes, unfortunately. Okay, so I accidentally pressed A before, but they were like, let's make her take point. So she's in the lead here. Oh, it says boba aren't real. Well, it's real. Mm-hmm. The Esper's got to be here. Move out. Okay, up we go. Imperial Magitek armor? Not even Narsh is safe anymore. Okay. Let's just fire beam them all down, I guess. So I might have made it louder for you all. Bring it down a bit again. Okay, let's get our head in the game. Pando has a magic girl cool armor. Seems like a good day for the Pando party. Agreed. They've got great, they did the battle song, you know? Do, 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 do. I'm so sorry, I feel like I have a very, very foggy brain today, so. Narsh's freedom depends on us! Oh no, not the doggos. The lobos. Nice. Sorry, in just 1 second, everyone. I'm just adjusting some stuff around here. It has been quite a while, hasn't it? Don't mess that up, but I would like this to be longer. Sorry, everyone. Okay. Here we go. Hey, Venom! It's totally cool. So, Regan Sick, you want to hear from the Murloc? So the Murloc has something to say to you. Thank you. You've been a wonderful audience. Mwah, 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 mwah. That was for you, Brig. Thank you so much for requesting me. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, sorry, I mean, wiggle, 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 wiggle. It is kind of funny that you upgraded all your tech to be pristine to play a JRPG from the 90s. Well, is this not the game, the JRPG you want to see in all its 1080p glory here? It is, Mr. Toastguard. How are you doing tonight? Panda will get a holodeck to say, computer, load a couch, a TV, and all my systems. I got JRPGs to play. Venom, that's legitimately exactly what I would do on a holodeck. Just one more fantasy, please. Okay, but this is the final fantasy. Hello, Tree Musher. How are you doing tonight? We've got him trapped now. Oh no, oh my. Pincer attack. Oh no. Regan Sig, there are VR games that let you sit on a couch and play ROMs on the TV. See, I don't want to put a headset on. I don't want that, Brigand Sig. If I wouldn't go into virtual reality in order to live a life I can already have. But the holodeck lets you recreate an area so it feels like I'm literally there. You don't get that same experience in VR, you know? I'll get the headset hair. I also, VR actually makes me, I don't actually get motion sickness at all, but VR makes me feel really yucky. Like, I always get a big headache from being in VR. It would be nice to have a big mech like that to commute. It's true, Tree Mosher. Just step on everyone. You're right, Brigand Sig. We have to start somewhere. So I moved over from Streamlabs to Stream Elements. Well, just actually to OBS Live and Stream Elements. Which I used to have everything set really low on Streamlabs because I was having a lot of streaming issues in the past. So everything was 720, 30 FPS. But now I'm streaming out at 1080p, 60 FPS. So I don't know if this is going to end up breaking on us or not. Or not. It's all the same hardware. It's just, yeah, I chose, I did some research. And we looked into switching over to this version, which has been working all right. Yeah, I was using Streamlabs up till Saturday. Pandawish bot is our Stream Elements bot, and when you go to, if you use the Stream Elements plugin in OBS Live, you get the, you get to rename your bot. So, now Pandawish bot, talks to us and is our special, bot named for Pandawish. We must defend the mines. Your Pando's loyal jackbooted thug now. I probably should move it to wait. I forgot. I always thought ATB was introduced on the PS1, but I probably should move it over to the new one. You know what I'm saying? According to our source, the frozen Esper was found in a new mine shaft. Maybe this one. Let's go into the config. Oh, it's set to wait already, so that's good. I'd usually leave it on active, but because I'm blah blah blahing so much in chat, we need the wait. An eerie glow surrounds you. Want info about save points? Nah, I know how they work. Oh, the music is so similar to like Final Fantasy VII and VIII-ish kind of music at this point, like that very like bum ba bum bum. To the Jokobo screen? Oh, I need to see that. Okay, let's do it. I will heal her next time. Those are not friendly looking. Xerix, what is this save? Save. Okay, let's see here. Oh, here we go. Oh, perfect. Yes, I would like to save my game, please. This is absurd. Oh my gosh, should we keep this background? It's worse than I thought it could ever be. I can't go in there, huh? Saved, ding. It is a bit. Oh gosh, yes. Okay, that's it gets worse. Yeah, I think that the old Panda-rooney here. Even I can't handle these chocobos. Okay, config. Oh gosh, I can barely read anything. We'll go nice traditional Final Fantasy blue, you know what I'm saying? Tree Mosher, legend says the Chosen One will use the Chocobo background on Final Fantasy VI when the world watches on a Monday. Oh my gosh, and what is the Chosen One gonna do? Hey Black Rose, how are you doing tonight? So great to see you. Yes, it is a very classic blue. You're right, Venom. I'll handle this. Stand back. Green and yellow for the Packers. In Final Fantasy, Breaking Sick. In Final Fantasy VII, you always make the background colors green and yellow for the Packers. That's pretty good. I've never really messed with that stuff, honestly. We won't hand over the Esper. Welk, get them. Oops. Look at that, Welk. Hold it. Think back to our briefing. What about it? Do you recall hearing about a monster that eats lightning and stores the energy in its shell? Right, so whatever you do, don't attack the shell. All right, already. Okay, don't attack the shell. The standard blue is a really good look. I agree, Gurf. Tree Mosher, you don't know. You stopped reading the prophecy at that because it sounded silly. You were like, what is it? What even is this? Right? Don't attack the shell. That's on you, Pando. Oops. Sorry, Vix. That's a bad Pando move there. There he is. Let's get him. So he's retreating now? Yeah. Okay, well that's nice. We'll just wait for him then. What can you do when you live in a shoe? It's a really valid question, Venom. Groo. Come back to me, Welkish Snail. Oh no! Kill him before he- oh, jeez. Okay, well that's gonna suck for you. Hoochie woochie. Like when- Venom, when company comes over, do they take off their shoes still? What the heck was that? If you're really determined, you can spend an hour in the fight and kill the shell. The reward is not worth it. It doesn't sound worth it. We got a potion. Can we revive our buddy? I don't know if we need to or not, but whatever. Let's roll out. I'm sure it doesn't matter soon enough anyway. This is the Frozen Esper. Uh-oh. Hey, what's the matter? Do you know something we don't? The frozen creature began emitting an eerie light. Where's that light coming from? Wah! Hey! Wedge, where are you? What's happening? See ya, nerds. Venom, a cat wandered into your yard. Your kids shouted at the top of their lungs, kitty, and the cat booked it out of there. They were like, no, thank you. Where am I?
Whoa, and I only just removed the crown.
Head hurts. Check the clock? Oh, is there a clock in here I can inspect in the game?
Easy.
Oh, easy.
This is a slave crown. The others had complete control over you while you were wearing it.
The grandfather clock? Yes. Okay, great. Pando clock? Always at 1 second. I can't remember a thing.
Don't worry. It'll all come back to you. In time, that is.
A mysterious young woman controlled by the Empire and born with the gift of magic. Ah, yeah. Hello, Tara. My name is Tara.
Impressive. I've never heard of anyone recovering this fast. Open up! Give us back the girl and the Empire's Magitek armor! Open this door! Open this door! We want that girl! She's an officer of the Empire!
You would totally see it through? Oh, thank you so much, Venom. Empire? Magitek armor? Let's go! Hey, how was your walk, Jumplest?
Look, I have to get you out of here. I don't have time to explain. Over here.
Okay, well, we're just gonna inspect this, the old mat, the clock here. Ooh, an elixir, nice. Anything in the treasure chest? I mean, the coat of armor? No. Warm myself by the fire? No, okay, okay. Worth a shot. Maybe I'll just go back to bed? No, okay. Always check the clocks. Good tip.
Make your way out through the mines. I'll keep these brutes occupied. She's up there!
Uh-oh. Better get moving. It's good, except you are cursed such that every time you come to any intersection on a walk, a car pulls up at the most awkward possible time for it to be unclear whether you should slowly walk in front of them or wave them on. I always hang back a little bit so it looks like I'm not about to cross. And then let them go. But yeah, that's always annoying, huh, Jumplust? Do anything down here? No? Okay. Ooh, yeah, random battles. Love it. The weird rats. The not friendly chews. Wave them on, then walk in front of them and collect the insurance. But now you're drinking brown sugar milk with boba, so you can't complain. Jump blessed, I'm drinking blueberry boba. Yay! I love to really get myself super injured. Break my neck. In order to get some of that hot insurance money. Uh, Yeah, over-emotional robot. Where is the Weir Rat plush, right? I want the slavering little jaws and drooly face. Also, I just want to point everyone's attention. Do you notice we have a rotating Nug Pika emote up by my season 12 text? Oh, look, there he goes. I'm very impressed with it. And it looks so good. I love it. Venom, Pando, we are Americans. Our forefathers endowed us with the unalienable belief that you always have the right of way, whether you walk or drive. Of course. Is it like a smoothie or something? It's kind of similar to a smoothie. It has the tapioca balls in it. It's called bubble tea or boba, regionally, depending on what you're into. I believe its origins come from Taiwan, but it's very big over here in Edmonton. But in lots of other places too. There's a lot of flavors, a ton of flavors. A world of flavors in bubble tea. The part I would probably opera anyway. They are a myth to upcharge you for sweet tea. Oh, look, we leveled up already. Look, ooh, treasure chest. Hello. Honestly, a phoenix down. Oh, no. What kind of translation is this? I'm glad I see this really bad phoenix down, but they're like, were they like, they won't know what a phoenix is, so. Oh, that makes sense, Gurf. Right, the space constraints. Right. It's a phoenix down. So just a thought here. What am I thinking about? Oh gosh, I can't even think what I'm thinking about. Oh right. So the music here is very reminiscent of like Final Fantasy VII and VIII era kind of music. And I would say that this, like Final Fantasy VI, VII, and VIII, I think are more commonly attuned musically than VII, VIII, and IX, like than they are with IX. I know. I'm so sorry. I'm all over the place. I need more of this. Need some caffeine in my brain. I don't know. I am Koopo for Koopo nuts tonight, folks. I can't keep it straight. No, I said it has incredible music. Yes, coffee and bubble tea smoothie combo. It's actually a tea and tea combo, but Nine has really great music too, Venom. I'm just saying that there's commonalities between 6, 7, 8 that are more in common with each other than I think 9 has with 7 and 8. Do you know what I mean? Despite the fact that it's like the PS1 era, 6 sounds a lot like 6, like 7 and 8. I think it might really be that little bassy like music thing, like the ba-bum boom. Like that kind of like, yeah, like the little snaps in there. It just, something about it, it's so perfect either way. It's like exceptional music. The last time I played was on my GBA Jump Plus, and I would say it was probably maybe 6 or 7-ish years ago. That's true. That's true, LaPanda Face. It just, I always, you know, you always think of 7, 8, and 9 as being the ones that are, like, the same, but I think 6, 7, and 8 have more in common to me. This one's Umatsu's favorite work? Ooh. I mean, it's all, like, I'm already just in love with the music in this game. Like, bar none. Okay, skills, heal up. Got her. Uh-oh. Oh, how convenient. We just break all of our legs. No more monkeys jumping on the bed. All, yes, all two of my legs. You're right, Jophis. My sweet little magic user. With the slave crown, I'll practically own you. Wah, 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 wah. Oh no. Remember the atrocities that we committed with for Kefka? Oh, I'm so excited. Thank you. Yeah, Pando Kefka. yes. Good. Burn up everything. Oh, no. Oh, no, Kefka. Oh, is that Celis? We stand on the brink of a major breakthrough. In the days to come, we'll witness a total revival of magic. It is our destiny and ours alone to take this mystic force and claim what is rightfully ours. With our newfound power, nothing can stand in our way. Hurrah! Long live Emperor Gestal! Or Gestal! The Cyclad is just a wild MacGuffin. It never comes up again after this. Wow, that's crazy. As much as you love Nine, Kefka's the better pure villain. Sephiroth, Eden, and Kuja just don't compare. Totally. You do like Sin, though. Sin is eternal and a whale. Took you long enough? How goes the robbing and plundering trade? Oh. Treasure hunter and trail-worn traveler, searching the world over for relics of the past. Hello, Locke. I prefer the term treasure hunting. Ha! Semantic nonsense. There's a huge difference. Venom and you over emotional robot are like the Biggs and Wedge to my Kefka. I love the little pose. You love the little pose that you. I do too. I love. There's something about that. You know, 2D sprites, the 16-bit era and the 32-bit era sprites. Like when we play Suikoden, love the sprite work there. Anyway, were you the one who sent for me? Xerix is my lock. Yeah, there's a girl I'd like you to meet. This better not have anything to do with that Magitek riding Imperial Witch.
Imperial troops are pursuing her even as we speak. This town is no match for the Empire. Our independence can only be assured if we join forces with the Returners, an underground resistance movement. That girl wasn't responsible for her actions. We must get her to understand our dilemma. All right, I think we'd better help her. He really did a 180 there, went from witch to, yeah, let's help her. Agreed. Make your way first to Figaro and talk to the king. Or is it Figaro? Like Figaro, Figaro, Figaro. I'm everyone, Venom. Oh, right. I see what you're saying. Who does Zarex think Venom is? Or who does Zarex think Zarex is? Oh my gosh. You don't remember the witch part at all? Now we gotcha. Oh, look, it's Mount Condor. Wonderful. There's a whole bunch of them.
Koopo?
Moogles, are you saying you want to help me?
Koopo!
Moogle, use us to save Terra from the guards. Need more information? Yeah, sure. Name that Mog Zarex. You'll fight using three different groups. Press the Y button to switch between them. Your job is to defeat the commander of the guards before his men reach Terra. Save her, or else. Oh no, right here, I guess? Then right here, I guess? Okay, good enough. Oh gosh, I hope they can handle it on their own. Ouchie, wouchie, Mogaroony. Mastered a new dance. I love all their names. Kupek, Lock, Kupop, Kumama. Mog is pretty buff, it's true. Oh, ouchie, wouchie. Kumama is Mog's mama? Yeah! It's the whole Koopo family. Hey, Ruler of Inches, how you doing tonight? Let's go Kushu, Kurin, Kuru, and Kumog. Kamog. I have played it off stream, Ruler of Inches. Like, I played it when it first came out. But are you suggesting I play it on stream? Yes. Well, that definitely could be in the cards, Ruler of Inches. Maybe add Nude Game Plus it there. The year is 2021. Mog has just mastered flossing. You're waiting for the PS5 version? Nice. I don't know if, can we survive this?
I don't know when I'll get a PS5 ever, but I think it'll be okay. Hey, Chocobo Will, thank you so much for the resub. Yahoo! 3 months. Holy smokes, what's going on? How you doing tonight? Hi, Mothy. Do I have to keep moving down with these guys? Or do I just go to the main guy now? Oh, there we go. It's true. How have you been, Chocobo Will? Yes, today's the beginning. Final Fantasy VI. I've actually played it twice, but I've never beaten it either time. And I haven't made it very far. So this is going to be a very big deal. No, no, no. On yes, please. Oh, Finnegan's. Oh, yeah, stealing, right. Oh, okay. Question for chat then. Do I want to steal a lot in this game? Like steal from the bosses like Final Fantasy IX style? Or what do you think? Yes, Kumama, no! Venom, in a world where JRPGs have all gone to Dark Souls action, one Pando dares to play every JRPG ever made. It's so true. It's sour. Steal is mostly worthless. LePandaFace loves it, but there are a few rare items, but nothing you'll miss on a normal playthrough. Okay. There are a few enemies you definitely want to steal from, but that's later. Okay, well, tell me what those are. I probably will not steal a lot in that case. I'm going to use this one Phoenix down. Oh, no. Oh, no. Koopop and Koomama. Should I revive them, or should I just try to survive? Oh, Finnegan's. Why is this happening to me? Oh, do I just keep blasting my party down here? I don't really understand what I'm doing here. I don't remember that guy being so strong. The KO'd Moogle Slight is, sprite is very sad. I very much agree. Okay, so it didn't give me a... Preset and go kill that shell. With a dance? Okay, okay. Then I will take this group in with me. Oh wow, yeah, Mog is a beast. A tankaroony. What does Dusk Requiem do? Oh, that? Very good. Oh no, okay. Hit bonk! Okay, well that worked out this time. Will you leave your friends behind? Great question, Captain Giraffe. Hello, Shockwave773. How are you doing tonight? Welcome to the Pando Party. Okay, oh dear. It's
Thanks, Moogles. We're in your debt. Run! Run, Locke, run! Dead Moogs litter the ground. I love this music. This music is so killer. I think the switch'll. Eh? You back with us now?
You saved me?
Save your thanks for the Moogles.
I can't remember anything, past or present.
Right, Shockwave? So I definitely have played this game twice, but I actually have never beaten it, Shockwave, and I haven't actually made it further than what chat was telling me was about a quarter of the way. I've played through so many JRPGs and finished so many Final Fantasies, but this one has always been a sore spot for me that I've never actually finished it. So, yeah, I'm really excited to actually go through and beat the game this time. Locke Canadian confirmed. You have amnesia?
Man said my memory would come back.
Give it time. You're safe with me. I give you my word. I won't leave you until your memory returns. By the way, this secret entrance might be useful someday. Don't forget about it. I got to the part where Terra goes like full Esper. She becomes all glowy and crazy and flies all over the place, and the team has to go find her when she crash lands. That's the part I remember. This is a classroom for the beginner. Here we answer your questions about the world. Think of us as your advisors. Shockwave, you've beat it twice. This and Chrono Trigger to you are the two greatest JRPGs RPGs ever made. Aw, yeah! Final Fantasy party time! Excellent! Hello, Darkwing! Shockwave, I super agree with you. I think Chrono Trigger is incredible. I've definitely beaten that now. But yeah, I'm really crazy for these games. They're so, so good. Terra goes full Luna. She might be Althina level. This is water from a recovery spring. It'll restore your HP and MP. Such springs are located throughout the world. Got it. All right. You already told me that. So what's going on here? If you select the wait battle mode from the config menu, you can take all the time you need to select spells or items without being attacked. Okay, sounds good. Okay, I think we don't need to learn about this stuff. I have played many an RPG before. I'm pretty sure I know all this stuff. But can I use your save point?
Indeed I can.
But yeah, Shockwave, if you're into RPGs, you've come to the right place. This is RPG Central. Oh, monster in a box. Oh, is this gonna be okay? Oh, really, Xerix? Thank you. I had no idea. If I select attack in battle, my character will attack. That's wild. Hey, Shockwave, thank you so much for following. Welcome to the Pando Party. Woo, 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 woo. Ding. Cactuar pose. See, you got a cactuar back there. What's going on? What? That's why I keep dying, right, LaPanda Face? Xerix here giving us the clutch tips. So Darkwing, I'm actually playing on a SNES Classic. We're not playing on the Switch. I don't think this even is on the Switch in any capacity. I'm playing on a Super Nintendo Classic. I actually own this game, alright. Eh? Who might you be? No one, thanks. This is the pits. We better hightail it southward to Figaro.
Okay, let's head out of here. Okay, cool. Okay. I didn't even see that one get added. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. Oh, yeah. Check out this mode 7, everyone. Woohoo. Oh, the panda face. You got you. Oh, you knew which one was yours. Narsha's so chill, right? Okay, so we're going to Figaro. I know this is the wrong way, so we're going to go back around this way. You memorized it. You knew it was your special one. So yeah, sorry, I'm thinking 7 things to Tuesday here. So I own the Final Fantasy Anthology, Final Fantasy VI, and I own the Game Boy Advance version, but when I was thinking about what to stream, I chose the SNES Classic version because, one, I didn't want the latency, the lag, and the loading times of the PlayStation 1 version, and I didn't want the squished look of the Game Boy Advance, so. Narsh. Yeah, the SNES graphics are fantastico. Plus, I don't know. I feel like this is the one that everyone's probably the most nostalgic for. Quotes are for all. It is. I really do love the feeling of these battles, though. They're really nice and zippy, you know? We learned antidote. Right, Square keeps doing that, where they keep, like, smoothing out and mobile phone making their graphics look a certain way. And I don't really know who they're trying to impress with that. I can't imagine anyone thinks it looks better. Because it doesn't. Right, Eggroll? I have no idea who wants the smooth sprites either. It just looks really weird. It's true, not their fans. If they're trying to attract new people, I wouldn't look at that and be like, yeah. It's true, Shockwave. The battles are so nice and zippy. They don't take an age. And I guess we're just coming out of, Mario here. Paper Mario is what we beat last, and yeah, this feels like heaven. Oh, I kind of wanted to go talk to these guys here. Okay, fine, I won't go talk to the guys in the chocobos. Thanks for my own shout out, Venom. Wait. Hey, oh, it's you. Proceed. Bum 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 bum. Oh yeah, this music is all so good. Basement 1. Oh hey, it's prison. Thanks for throwing the Discord link out there, Captain Giraffe. These thieves have been terrorizing the vicinity. Stay away from them. Okay, fine. I want to inspect this clock, though. Oh, I saw those Choco Knights, all right. You less mind the smooth sprites, Gurf, but they draw them all at side profile instead of the three-quarter profile the SNES sprites are, and they're terrible in comparison. It's so... very, very true. I never actually thought about that difference, Gurf, but you're right. I don't understand why they do that either. Le Panda Face, you told me to check all the clocks. I'm going to check every clock now. Every last one.
Beyond is the Figaro Castle engine room. We're ready to leave at a moment's notice.
So I keep saying Figaro, but is it like Figaro, Figaro, Figaro? So like what, Figaro?
That's dangerous.
Okay, fine. Maybe you should stand in front of the staircase at all times then, sir. Halibuts. Figaro? Okay, cool. Oh, he's standing in front of the switch, of course. Oh, totally. Sometimes with limitation shockwave, you might breed excellence. Yeah, because Nubo Umetsu hit his summit with this score considering the limitations he had. Amazing. So my favorite soundtrack is, soundtracks are definitely 7 and 8, but 6, incredible. There's a lot of opera references in this game, so if it's an opera term, that's probably the right one. Okay, Figaro. Figaro. Hey, Math Mission, how you doing? What's going on?
Go see the king.
I want to explore. I want to find treasures. Fine. It doesn't look like it, but this castle incorporates some of the most high-tech devices in existence. For example, oops, they're all top secret. Wow, okay, cool. Surviving the day? I'm glad to hear that. Anything here? Anything here?
Go see the king.
Well, now I'm going to explore the storerooms. Hi, can I help you? Oh, wow. Yeah, hello. I would like a phoenix down. Oh gosh, a tent? Oh, Finnegan's, be still my beating heart. Okay. We'll, let's get 10 of these. That feels good. Tincture? I don't even know what that does. We need some antidotes. Oh, 50 MP. Okay, if I press on it, it will show me. Okay, I know what the rest of these things do. But I want to wait till I can buy some gear. Oh, but speaking of gear, we did steal a mithril knife, I think. Nice. Oh, yes, Mothy, enjoy lurking since you're at work. Interesting, it's called tonic, right? Oh, thanks for the heads up, Math Mission. That's good to know. Are they over emotional, Robot? The character profile pictures in the updated versions are really nice. So is there a run button, or am I just... Oh, okay. I can't use any of these, can I? Okay. Weird. Perfect. Good night, Black Rose. Rest well. Have a great night. I'll get shoes. Perfect. Thank you for joining us, Black Rose. Ooh, got another phoenix down. Perfect. I'm the king of the world. Okay, out of here, sorry. Hello, sir. What's going on? Okay, well, that's all they're gonna say then, aren't they? Well, I think I'm just going to go into their quarters, actually. Do you mind? No? Okay, I guess that this is not a door.
You mean this young woman?
think you are.
Oh, sorry. How rude of me to turn my back to a lady.
The young king of Figaro Castle, allied to the Empire, and a master designer of machinery. Edgar, yeah.
I am Edgar, King of Figaro.
Surprised someone like me knows a king?
You're like, yes, yes. Talk to you later.
So, you're an Imperial soldier? No problem. Figaro and the Empire are allies.
The enemy sprites actually look okay in the mobile version, in your opinion. I can see that, probably the panda face, because they're like creatures, right? Edgar is a little bit of a creep. I kind of remember that. He's just a ladies' man, you know? It ain't no thing. No problem, no problem. Please, relax while you're here. It's not in my blood to harm a lady.
Look, why are you helping me? Is it because of my abilities?
Boys will be boys.
I'll give you 3 reasons. First of all, your beauty has captivated me. Second, I'm dying to know if I'm your type.
I guess your abilities would be a distant third.
What's with you anyway?
Guess my technique's getting a bit rusty.
I suppose a normal girl would have found him dashing, but I'm hardly normal.
Oh, is Tara an ace?
Sexual harassment panda alert.
Yeah, I think so. Feel free to wander about.
Will do.
I already did a lot of that, but thanks. Thanks, everyone.
Venom can be Edgar? Oh, no.
So if Tara was a 6, he would kick her to the curb now? Thank goodness Tara is hot. Our game would end here.
It might just. You're right.
Okay, now we can go this way.
Yeah, I do need a little rest. Thank you.
I did, Darkwing.
Though Edgar showers his attentions on women, most are too smart to pay any attention to him.
Oh, there's the answers.
He recently tried to hit on the High Priestess. Surely he's talked to you?
Jeez. Edgar, right? All the women who work here are like, yep, sexually harassed every day.
Tara is hot. She casts fire. But that shouldn't be all he thinks about. Too true.
This is Figaro, the desert castle.
Yeah, Chocobo Knights, what's going on?
Thanks. Edgar is actually a good person. I think he is. You're not wrong there, Zerix.
Edgar has a twin brother. He was such a nice boy.
Brother? What's wrong with father? What's all this talk of his successor?
La Panda Face, you like Edgar. Him and Sabine are really cool characters.
I bet they are. Math mission, there really aren't any bad characters that are in your party. You actually tend to care about Tara the least, but perhaps it's a bit unfair of you.
Venom. Mechanically, Edgar is great. The entire Machinist rework in Shadowbringers was to make it more like Edgar. Ooh, that's fun. Are you blind? Look how thin his face has become. What is it? Brother! Tears? Edgar's twin brother, who traded the throne for his own freedom. How's that been? What's going on? Yes, his name is Sabin. Oh, he looked so like his father. When he ran away, he was a sweet little child. I wonder what he's like now.
His Highness said he'd marry you when I got older.
Interesting. Interesting. He has a beard and some Amano artwork, which is pretty cool. Oh, I like the sound of that. That sounds really fun. The Empire has smashed the three cities on the southern continent. Just a matter of time till they come up here. The Empire, but were their allies? Anything else up here? Nine? Okay. Shockwave. Terra to use the heart and soul of Final Fantasy VI. Outside of Umaro, you can't think of a single blah character. Nice. Best character is Gogo. Oh, no thank you. Yeah, I think I like Terra a lot too, but I also tend to really like gal characters. No, Venom, I haven't. I'll really need to go through the other Final Fantasies as well. I've never beaten any of the older ones. I've played them all, but... Yes. Celeste is so good. It's 4. Or I believe that one's 4. Scholars the world over are doing research on magic. Silly people, scholars. Can I read the books? No. Long ago, a force called magic existed. People who use magic were called Mage Knights. Mage Knights! You like Terra. The amnesia trope is kind of overused, but you think she wears it well. Celeste is incredible. Yeah, agreed. Don't forget to check those scones. Sometimes, oh, those sconces, scones. Yes, don't forget to check the scones with the tea. Okay, that's good to know. I'll check the sconces now too. Scones. The best character is Shadow Dog. Okay. That's a good tip. I also learned to check clocks as well. So clocks is in sconces. I'll look at them all. Figaro, Figaro, Figaro. Gosh, it's still light out here and it's 8:37. That's bonkers. Like the light on the walls, like the lights where like you put candles in or stuff like that. Weapons and items manufactured here are sent to South Figaro. Great. It's going to snow tomorrow, math mission? Because the Midwest. Yes, we had the exact same thing this weekend. It was plus 17 Celsius here on Saturday. Very, very warm. And then the next day it was 1 and very, very chilly. Dogs are the best in any Final Fantasy they are in. Wish you could shoot a dog at someone in this game like an 8. Yeah. Right? Oh, that's so good. Renault just shoving a dog on her arm. Okay, still dangerous. Uh-oh. Ooh, bless my soul. Anything from this clock? No. These thieves have been terrorizing the vicinity. Stay away from them. Thanks, Eryx. April in Canada is just a wild card. It's so true, Captain Giraffe. You have no idea. Thanks, Eggroll Buddy. On the radio today, they were talking about some game-changing paint. They have invented a white paint that is so pure, they can paint buildings with it and the residents will never need to run the AC again. I heard of that, Venom, that it could really help with cooling efforts. Ooh, I'm spilling my drink everywhere. I can't turn it upside down. Oh, it's 8:39 here. Are you in the central time zone, Shockwave? I mean, you would be, I guess. All right. These sneezes are terrorizing the vicinity, Eggroll Buddy. It's so true. Hi, everyone. How you doing? Doing good? Having a nice time? Chicago? Oh, I see. I'm based in Canada, but in a city called Edmonton. I'm Lone Wolf, the pickpocket. Hi, Lone Wolf. Nice to meet you. How dare they arrest all those twins? Very true. Okay, so, I explored. Learned about Sabin. I am in Alberta! Hey, congrats on knowing what Alberta is. That makes me very happy. Gastal has harnessed the power of magic. Who can stop him now? Anything in those sconces? Do I go up top here? When will I find somebody to love? Okay, inspected. Messed around. What's up with this guy? He's new. The whole business of the succession was so repugnant to Sabin, the king's brother, that he fled the castle forever. The succession was settled with a coin toss. With a coin toss? Oh, hi, Edgar. Well, how do you like my castle? King Edgar! Someone from the Empire to see you! Probably Kefka. Phooey! Emperor Gestal's stupid orders! Edgar, you pinhead! Why do you have to live in the middle of nowhere? These Raycon jobs are the pits! Ahem. There's sand on my boots? Yes, sir! All set, sir! Oh god, I love the sound of the laugh. Idiots! Sir Kefka, what on earth do... Out of my way! Hello. I thought we were allies. What are you doing in my domain? You've been busy down south, looking for more cities to destroy? How do the Pando coins work? I think you have to gamble an amount behind the gamble, Darkwing. But, the Pando coins... I think I can eventually attach actual rewards to them. But if you click on that, you should be able to see how I allocate them and all the kind of stuff about Panda Coins there, I believe.
That's for us to know.
What brings Kefka, humble servant of Emperor Gestal, into our lowly presence?
A girl of no importance recently escaped from us. We heard she found refuge here.
This wouldn't have anything to do with this witch everyone's been whispering about, would it?
Lies! She merely stole something of minor value. Is she here?
That's a tough one.
You see, there are more girls here than grains of sand out there. I can't keep track of them all. I'd hate to be you if we found out you're lying. Mwaha!
I truly hope nothing happens to your precious Figaro.
Hey, Stanty Pants, how you doing tonight?
Oh, guess we're heading back.
What's going on? What's on the up and up?
This is an awesome game. Is it so true?
I'd say that guy's missing a few buttons. Where's Terra?
Take her to her room.
I'd love to chat with you, but the Chancellor and I must plan our strategy. Sometimes I hate being a king, if you'll excuse me.
Follow me.
Did he go this way?
He must have. Perfect. A little room for me to sleep.
Don't you worry about a thing.
You're Locke, right? Edgar told me about you. Is it true you're a thief?
That's treasure hunter.
On the surface, Edgar pretends to support the Empire. The truth is, he's collaborating with Returners, an organization opposed to the Empire. I am his contact with that group. The old man you met in Narsh is one of us.
Empire? But I'm a soldier of the Empire.
That's not true. They were using you. Things are different now.
I don't understand. What should I do?
I can't tell you what to do. You don't have to decide what right now. You'll find out. I can't talk. I'm so sorry. You don't have to decide right now. You'll soon find your way.
But how will I know which way is right?
Chat is just a gambling crazy. Hey, I'm glad that you guys are having a good time over there. Oh, the music got very scary and spooky.
What the?
What's happening? Clearly the place is on fire, sir.
It's the Empire! It's Kefka!
What are you doing?
Bring me the girl! Now!
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then, welcome to my barbecue! Wah-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha!
His barbecue, okay.
Fire, fire, hehehe. Fire! Fire!
Okay, do I go back the way I came? No, I guess I gotta... Get ready.
Yes, sir!
Changed your mind? I guess I have no choice. Or maybe I do.
Ack! Shameful that a king should flee, leaving his people behind. How utterly delightful.
Kefka gets stuff done. Okay, dive now. Yahoo! Figaro submerge mode activated!
No one can touch the people of Figaro!
Yep, it goes. It's gone. They can't. They're under the ground.
Go! Get them!
Oh dear. Okay, here we go. Edgar, what's the matter? You look positively spooked.
Did you just see what I saw?
Yeah, this kid seems loaded for bear.
She's amazing. That was magic.
Edgar's tools is OP in the beginning of the game. Oh, that's good to know. I'm very poor at ever using any of like that side stuff, so I'm glad to hear that.
That was magic. M-A-G-I-C. Magic? She used magic?
Tara, where on earth did you learn that?
Sorry, Look, I didn't mean to make such a big deal out of this.
Me either. It's just that I've never actually seen magic before. Where did you... I love how they're having this giant rigmarole about this while the Magitek armor guys are just sitting here and being like, what's going on?
The monkey paw curls.
So Captain Giraffe, it does not actually work as actual channel points. It's a separate point system within stream elements that I can attach secondary rewards to. At this moment though, they're just silly extra points that you can do stuff like the gamble and the duels and stuff with. Folks seem to like them, so we implemented them. But I don't currently have any rewards set up for the points at the moment. They're everything to us. Shockwave, it's so true. The cutscenes do have more personality in the 16-bit than many games now with graphics and Hollywood budgets. It's so, so true. Venom, you're a forever winner.
Uh,
Edgar, Tara can use magic and we can't. That's the only difference between us. The fact is, we could use her help.
Thank you, Locke. Thank you, Edgar.
Swoon. Okay. Oh dear. Okay. Item. Okay. We definitely need to use a Phoenix Down on our sweet gal now, because we need her to get those XPs. Oh yeah, you're right. Item, let's throw this tonic down on Tara. Oh, I should have used her fire, but whatever. Yeah, use a cure on yourself there, Tara. And decisive battle is the best boss battle theme ever. Ooh, I can't wait to hear all of that stuff, Shockwave. I actually don't know the titles of all of these songs, so feel free to point it out when we hear that stuff. Bravo, Figaro! Son of a submariner! They'll pay for this. Son of a submariner? This is great! Was that a bad person? I'm scared. Right, Falsy Bear? Hey, Falsy, how you doing tonight? So great to see you. Tara, there's someone I'd like you to meet. We're members of the Returners. Our mentor, Bannon, would certainly like to meet you. Magic is going to be the key to winning this war.
Magic?
Tara has magical powers. That Esper seemed to react to her. Can there be some connection?
Falsy Bear, you're playing a game you're also playing and you love it. Have you beat this game before, Falsy Bear? Oh, right. I'm glad to see these classic lines. I haven't the foggiest. It just seems natural to me that I have the use of this power.
But no human is born with the powers you seem to have, and...
Oh, so this is my first time beating it, Falsy. I actually have never beaten it before.
I apologize.
What should I do?
I'm sure the Empire is going to come after you. If they get their hands on you again, the world's finished. Tara, you want to understand your own powers, right? Then I think we need to consult with Bannon.
It's subtle moments like that that make the game good. Yeah, math mission. Oh, did I say that line? I forget. Please?
Okay, to the south there's a cave that leads to South Figaro.
Ooh, mode 7, everyone. Yeah, check it out. Okay, cave to the south. Okay, I think we're getting there.
Oh, I can't really walk on this stuff. Okay, Oh, here we go.
Mode 7 is incredible. It totally is. Okay, bye, Chocobo. Oops.
A Imagine if Zelda 2 was like this. The stuff Capcom, Konami, and Square did hold up so well. I bet. Going Uncle Scrooge with Pando coin. Where's the Lambo? Did you just call Terra an alien? He might have. Thank you for the save, Math. You know what? I don't think I got your save, but I'm going to save again, Math Mission, just because you requested it. Ding! King Edgar, where are you headed? Through the cave and eastward to South Figaro. Return to the castle and tell the others we're safe. Yes, sir. Take care. Agreed, Math Mission. So, okay. Another thing that you might not know, Venom, is that I actually, over the weekend, I actually updated the allocation of all those, of all these imaginary points. So you earn them a lot faster than previously. So you're probably just finding that you're earning them back really fast. And a lot of people actually haven't been here for a while, so yeah, you're earning a lot of points really real fast. Recovery spring. Yeah, look at the little turtle hanging out here. Oops, I actually should have done. Oh wait, tools. Yeah, do that. So is there no MP bar yet, or is it just invisible? Okay, Xerex, thank you so much for hanging out. Have a really good night and a great rest, and hopefully we see you soon. Rest well, be safe, and have a great night. No MP bars in this version. Great to know. Pando's learning things right now. Right, I figured that was the case. But, you know, I just wanted to know anyway. So we gotta explore the caves closely and find all the treasures. I like these eyeball creatures. What are they, the Blearies? Oh, I should have used. Very creative names. Right, imagine meeting them, you'll be like, imagine that meeting where they're creating them. Well, I imagine that their Japanese names are probably quite different. Or maybe not. Hello, Michael Bevel. How are you doing tonight? I'm doing very well. Thank you so much for asking. My tincture. Captain Giraffe, are you telling me, so you'd be weirded out if you ever met something with the eye in the size of your head? Gee, I wonder why that would be. Welcome to Pando Coins. Get rich or die trying. I have a feeling that. Not really ever any different than a D&D game. One day you're in a town trying to buy some loot. The next day you're fighting some owlbear mutant. You're right. It's very true. Hey Rod, how's it going tonight? You got some Mongolian beef and some hot and sour soup. Greetings from Phoenix. How are you doing, Rod? So great to see you. This treasure chest that I'm coming up on, remember it. It'll be important later. Darkwing, you missed the good old days of clearing out a few kobolds. Nowadays, DMs want you to fight the final boss from Stranger Things. Okay, the one that I just opened, or? Nice. That's one of my favorite times on a trip when you've like done a whole bunch of stuff and then you're like, I get to just kind of chill and do nothing right now. Okay, not that one. Venom, what's your go-to Chinese food order? Michael Bevel, you're fine. Thanks for asking, but just a little bit dozing off now. Just wanted to pop in for a couple of minutes and also hang out. So don't be mad, but you were hanging out with Jay from Jay and Silent Bob a little bit ago. Hey, that's fun. That sounds like a nice time. You need an egg roll, buddy. Oh yeah, good job, Tara. You leveled up. You want pork friend rice? Well, I'm concerned for that one. It's my pork friend. Okay, I should start using Edgar's tools because you're right, it is OP and I just keep forgetting to do it. Yeah, see you later, bugs. So I can really just spam that and have a great time. You're sleepy and hungry. What a combination. Friend rice seems like an earthbound item, right? Everyone's back slowly away from Venom. I love to wander and explore in these things, so. They're all fine. Okay, thanks, Mathmission, for letting me know. If I start just screaming your name, you'll come help me, I'm sure. Oh, nothing here. Oh, okay. I see. I went all the way through. Oh, wait, no. I came in from that direction. Then what's over here? We gotta go up that way. Oh, I think I'll actually heal Locke now. Skills, Terra, magic, cure. Nice. Oh, that's a good... Her cure is very powerful. Okay, just one chest. Got it. Tinchker. Woohoo. Okay. Love it. That looks like it should be a door, but it's not. Oh, Michael Bevel, never worry about that kind of stuff. I'm a very chill streamer around here. I think if maybe all you were doing was, talking about it. Holy Mr. Bubbles 137, thank you so much for the gift subs.
Tier 1 sub to Charles underscore the underscore elder.
Aw, I really appreciate that. Thank you so much for the gift subs. Oh, thank you, thank you.
Gifted a tier 1 sub to generation underscore 71.
How are you doing today? And yes, this is actually my second time I've ever played this game, but my third time I've ever actually played this one, but I've never beaten it either time, so I'm really excited to finally get through it, Mr. Bubbles. Oh yeah, thank you so much for all those gift subs. It really means a lot to me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now we can spread the Pika hype. Who's that Pokemon?
Who's that Pokemon?
Best character is Def Gogo. You know, I don't think I've ever met Gogo in this game, but maybe I have. I love those Pokemon drops. Yeah, how many times have you beat this game, Mr. Bubbles? And Michael Bevel, like I said, don't worry, it's a chill place. Yes, Michael Bevel, I beat it on Saturday evening. He's the guy you find in the suck dude. Yeah, I've never beaten this game before. I don't think I've even gotten far enough to see a ton of the best stuff. I guess. So you have all the pictures and video from October 31st. What capacity size of storage media would you need? Great question, my friend. What would it be? I know there's no door here. Deeds, hello! You beat it numerous times on the SNES, Mr. Bubbles. Yeah, you find it in the Veldt. Oh, okay, okay. Deeds, it's so great to see you. How are you doing tonight? We've just escaped to escaping to Figaro. A terror by Barah, that's good, Barunch. I'm so happy to have you here, Deeds. Okay. Is that it? We just walked out of here? All done? Well, let's throw a little Savy Roo down. That was okay. Oh, yeah, I guess, all that stuff is gonna be new to me. I actually have never seen it all, so I'm really excited to experience it all, Mr. Bubbles. Good job, Tara. In the forest. Okay, skills, Tara. You need to heal. The music is incredible, Mr. Bubbles. I definitely agree with you. 120%. It's exceptional. Welcome to South Figaro. I got your king with me. Do you recognize? You'll find lots of excellent weapons, armor, and relics in our shops. Okay. Good. Aw, nice. Antidote. Ooh, eye drop. Oh, okay. Investigate boxes and everything. I will do that. Beyond Mount Colts, you'll find the Sibyl Mountain Range. Oh, this is good music here. All right, and it's a cafe, right? Because children play this game. There is no alcohol here. The guy at the counter, he's kind of creepy.
The Empire's been invading one town after the next. We are not safe here. Are kids allowed in here? What do you think? Oh, all right.
Duncan students have no peers.
Hey, Mr. Bubbles, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Pando Party. Woo, 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 woo. Ding, cactuar pose.
It's all seltzer water, of course. Milk bar.
Duncan students have no peers.
Of course they don't.
Duncan made his son, Vargas, practice a strict martial arts lifestyle. Vargas resented it.
Oh, yeah? Oh, hello. Oh, here's the best boy, right?
At the very least, you could give me a response. Stand back. He seems vaguely familiar. Wait a minute.
Ooh, best doggo in game. In any game, maybe.
He owes allegiance to no one and will do anything for money. He comes and goes like the wind.
Aw, yeah. Check it out. Ninja man.
Shudu?
Shudu.
That shadow. He'd slit his mama's throat for a nickel.
Better steer clear of him, I guess. His name is Egg Deeds. Okay, well, we got a shadow name here.
Oh, yes, Captain Giraffe, thank you so much for sharing our Discord. Please, if anyone's interested who's watching and not part of the Discord already, please give our Discord a join. It's a great place. We hang out, have a nice time in there, and chitter chatter all the dang time.
Okay, I can't talk to this barkeep. I'm trying to, but he does not want to talk to me, so that's fine. Please name Kane Deeds if I play Final Fantasy IV. Oh, thank you so much, Jump Lust. Enjoy your movie. Tell me what movie you watched later, if you can.
Out of the way. I gotta get the cider over to the old man. That's my job. Now scram.
Okay. Yes, the cider. Hey, cider can be alcoholic too, so... Okay, I know I checked this kettle already, but I'm double checking it because I can. And I will.
Oh, and you know, because we're here in a Pando-ish season 12, episode 1, I will have to put up a poll for season 13.
So, controversial opinion, but best Final Fantasy is as follows. Final Fantasy VI, Final Fantasy VIII, then Final Fantasy V.
Mr. Bubbles! That's so fun! So, Final Fantasy VIII is actually my favorite Final Fantasy. So, it's great to find folks who also like Final Fantasy VIII. I, love it. Love, love, love it. Just call it sour corn mash? Mashed potato fan, how you doing tonight? You know, Final Fantasy V is also one I haven't beaten yet, so we're going to have to do that eventually, too, with the Pando Party purpose. Oh, right, Mr. Bubbles? Final Fantasy VIII is by far my favorite Final Fantasy music completely. There it is, Deeds, the Pando Party purpose. Oh, I haven't updated it for what we're currently playing. Finnegan's. I gotta update that. Live update my Pando Party purpose. My dashboard.
And because we're done with the Final Fantasy, you know, whatever the, I mean, the, and we're done with Paper Mario. It's true. A false advertising. Oh no. Oh, Finnegan's. Okay, where is my bot information here? Okay, modules, chat commands, custom commands, the PPP, edit it, please. Currently playing through Final Fantasy VI. Final Fantasy VI. Up next, stay tuned. We don't know yet. Okay, now the PPP has been updated. Woo! That was a close call. I was heckin' spooked there for a minute. Wait, I thought this was Paper Mario. Finnegan is, I have no idea what Finnegan is, honestly. It's a name. It's a good way to swear, I guess. Ranko Fett, thank you so much for following. Welcome to the Pando Party. Woo, 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 woo! Ding! Cactuar pose! Imagine the lawsuits. Yep, new season. You love Bland Gardens music and Fisherman's Horizon so much. Ugh, me too, Mr. Bubbles. I actually also am crazy for Blue Fields, the world map music in that game. Bum 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 bum. You're gonna sue the Pando Party, please. Pando Party needs all your love and support, and no suing. Oh, Deez, that's so fun. Thank you for bringing someone over here. Well, hey, they always get the dance. It belongs to you. That's so... I like that. I like that, Deez, a lot. Hey, look at this person sleeping. Let's talk to them and be a creep. The Empire attacked Figaro Castle? Now we'll all be drawn to the battle. Guess he better goes to sleep still. Figaro was a little kitty cat, a little kitty cat, a little kitty cat. Figaro was a little kitty cat. No food for kitty. Cleo was a little bitty fish, a little bitty fish, a little bitty fish. Ooh, what do you got for me? Sprint shoes, goggles, star pen. Okay, well, this stuff will be important, but I need to actually get weapons. Dancing Mad or Terra. Oh, you'll have to, I don't know all the names of these songs, obviously, off by heart, so I'll definitely need a heads up when the good songs are happening. I mean, I'll know them, but I like to know their names, too. Venom, it's Monday. You can do your chores slow. That's a good quote over Emotional Robot. Oh, before the end of the world. Oh, okay, okay. Sounds good. Equip relics to gain a variety of abilities. These double my walking speed. Oh, I do want that. Oh. Relics give your party members a variety of abilities. For example, sprint shoes double your speed. True Knight lets you shield others during battle. Dragoon boots add the jump command to your battle list. Gauntlet allows you to hold a sword with both hands. Use the main menu to equip up to 2 relics per person. Okay, so I'm definitely going to buy some sprint shoes then. So I can equip those. I just would like to not, be very slow. You know what I'm saying? Oh, the relics are on a different menu? Ah, yes, indeedy-do. I see it. You love using it again. Oh, there we go. Oh, that feels good. Silver Deeds boots? The ending credits song medley is the number one Final Fantasy song, period. Rango Fett, I love a good ending theme in a Final Fantasy game for sure. All right, so we talked to this guy. Okay, hi, kid. Talk to me.
I can't believe it. The Empire will smash us.
I don't think you should be green cherry. What on earth is that? And I guess, you know, I'll just throw this out here right now. I've somehow managed to avoid spoilers for the end of this game, despite the fact it's, like, a very old game at this point. So, maybe I'll just note, like, I don't know the ending or kind of the big turns in this game. So, if we could be chill on that, I'd appreciate it. Has war really begun? I'd better return home.
Hey, that's okay, Deflag Ratio.
I'm not like gonna be too worried about it. I just, you know, a thought to mention. Ooh, an elixir. Hello, clock elixirs. You've heard of Tifa Lockhart. Well, now there's a food. Beef a lamb kebab. You're as Dark Souls. Okay, Pando, if you could wipe your memory and play one game for the first time again, what would it be? Gorsh. I don't know. I'm trying to think of a game that, like, blew my mind. That I'd want to experience it for the very first time again. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe Persona? True. I guess I'm just not too worried about spoilers, but at the same time, you know. It'd be Super Metroid for you. It was such a good game when you were like 6. Rango Fight, yours is probably KOTOR. You know, I've never actually played a KOTOR game. I would really like to, though. I've heard such good things about them. I played on the Mass Effects, which I know is not KOTOR, but, you know, it has a history, a shared lineage. Earthbound, great choice. You know, mine would probably be Persona 4. Game Detective, what's going on? What's on the up and up? So great to see you. Attack from the east. That way... Hey, what do you think you're doing? Barging in here while I'm trying to write a letter. Huh. Oh, sorry. Even a millionaire can be startled.
There's always a nasty draft in this room. Where's it coming from?
From the secret door hidden back here, perhaps? Mm-hmm. I could walk up there now. Yeah. Yeah, Persona 4 actually is one of my favorite games of all time. Mass Effect 1 was so good when you first played it. You've played it so many times. Yeah. I love Mass Effect. I think 2 is my favorite, though. Hey, Bryce, y'all! Thank you so much for the raid! Hello, everyone! Hi, how are you doing, Bryce, y'all? Thanks for the raid! Shout out to Bryce, y'all. What were you playing? You're playing some Smash Brothers Ultimate tonight. Very nice. Bryce raid. Hello, everyone. I am Pando. I play almost exclusively JRPGs on this channel while also doing voice acting for anything that didn't previously have voice acting. I've played through a lot of JRPGs. I'm revisiting a lot of classics. See the PPP here. I've never finished Final Fantasy VI either, Bryce, y'all. So if that all sounds fun to you, thank you so much for joining us today. Feel free to give me a little follow-a-roo. I play through everything in a single, well, not in a single go, but I play through everything from start to finish. Refined Legends, thank you so much for following. Welcome to the Pando Party. Woo, 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 woo. Dang, cactuar pose. How was your stream tonight, Bryce, y'all? The furthest I made it, Trickster Mix, was the part where Tara goes Koopo for Koopo Nuts. And then you go collect her again. But that's it. That's as far as I've gotten. Ooh, a save point. I love to find a save point. Oh, Mr. Bubbles, I have absolutely played and finished Chrono Trigger. I've actually played through a bajillo tons of these older games. There's just some I never got around to finishing, you know? Okay, there's clearly... Okay, I can't get over here. Oh, there we go. Oh. 500 GP, nice. I am Mr. Bubbles. I have played an old clock. It's ticking. Okay, that one's just ticking. Ooh, 1,000 GP. I'm rich! Yeah, that's this Pando here. Love the RPGs. I grew up playing games like when I had an NES. Then I had a Genesis because that's just what my parents liked and I was too young to make those decisions for myself. But then when I was, you know, in grade 6-ish, the 64 came out and I fell madly in love with it. So I got one way after years of asking. With Ocarina of Time, which made me discover that story games were a thing. Because at that point, I had just been playing through platformers. Well, this one's not ticking. So I was like, wow, story games, huh? And then people were like, well, you like story games. You should play a Final Fantasy. And it was over for me from there. From that moment on, I'm in my mid-30s now. And I've been hardcore into video games. Since I was, like, you know, 14, so. You actually have a Mog onesie? Very nice. You actually beat the game 4 to 5 times. No better genre than a good old RPG. I agree. I think a lot, like, I love modern ones as well, but gosh, they get so long, right? You know why they call it a gill, right? Because after a while, you're swimming in it. You've been buying stuff up on the PSN lately. Need to get your JRPG backlog at some point. Totally, Bryce, y'all. That's the reason why I started streaming is so I could finally clear out my backlog. Mr. Bubbles, you can't remember your mom waiting outside for hours to get a 64 for you and your sister when you were in middle school? Yeah, exactly. My family, we couldn't really afford one right away, but you bet I asked every Christmas and hoped that the price had dropped enough for my parents to finally get me one.
Chung, 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 Magitek armor! My dad's very important. Why, not so long ago, he even dined with General Leo. I just made that up.
Suspicious. Right, Shockwave? I mean, don't get me wrong. I play through all the modern RPGs as well. I play through all everything, though. Like, even, you know, I was going to say RPGs are so long, but so is, like, Assassin's Creed. Like, the new Assassin's Creed. Like, anything open world is just flipping huge and massive and takes 800 years to beat. Still do it, though, right? Games are just getting longer and longer, which that's fine. I love it. I love it, but... There is just such an embarrassment of games to play at any given time. You get a backlog really easily. Yeah, modern RPGs are great, but it's hard to capture the magic of the SNES or PS1 era. Yeah, my nostalgia for PS1 era JRPGs is just second to none. The first game you went crazy for was Ocarina of Time. I was so obsessed with it for the 64. Mr. Bubbles, I'm legitimately exactly the same way. Ocarina of Time is the first game I, like, was obsessed with. Like, I could think about it. I go to sleep thinking about Ocarina of Time. What's going to happen next? How do I fix this? What's going on? It was just, you know, everything I could think of. Okay, so Regal Cutlass will give that to... Okay, you'll take that. We'll give this to... Oh, I don't need 11 of them. I'll take 2 of them. Okay, lock. No. Equip Edgar with a Regal Cutlass. Totally nice. Can take the blade. Nice. Child is sus. I vote her for Aralok. Right? She's deeply suspicious to Flagratio. You missed the 30-hour RPG. Take 2 weeks and done, right? That is not the case anymore. I just beat, when I beat Persona 5 Royal, it was 140 hours, and I was like, huh. Yep, 140 hours. True story. You once got into a nasty argument on the playground about General Leo. Really over-emotional robot? What about? Shockwave, you got a slew of games last year, such as Nioh 2, Sekiro, and Ghost of Tsushima, and got a Sega Genesis Mini, which now has 122 games in total. Very easy to get lost in the shuffle. So easy. When I definitely want to get it. I get into this rant a lot, but I have a lot of folks who always say, I don't know, I don't really play new games anymore. They're just not as good. And I'm like, why are we playing the same games? Because there's so many of them all the time that are so good. You know? There's just so many good games. You can finish a game in 30 hours if you're speedrunning, right? Pando, they sell grape juice as 25% sugar reduced. Is that so? Assassin's Creed right now is enter a room puzzle. Want to leave the room puzzle? Beautiful game, but it's just, oh my gosh, let me find said item and walk out. I used to love it for all the historical stuff and like all the history lessons they'd give you, but they don't seem too keen in doing that stuff anymore. This kid claimed there was a secret way to get him as a permanent party member, and you were just not having it. Oh, I love those school ground arguments, right? Yeah, plume tat, please. Kung Fu suit, absolutely. Now we're rocking. Leather hat. Plume tat. Okay, well, you're just gonna be stuck with that. Heavy shield. Hairband and the cotton robe. Perfect. Getting a Mass Effect Legacy Collection for your birthday, and all three original games take around 30 hours to complete. It's true. Yes, I've played a lot of Mass Effect. It's actually not bad. It's like light. Kind of like how salad is light compared to a steak. Of course. Mr. Bubbles, you feel like a lot of the new games are not as good as older ones and rarely find anything good. You mean you really only play WoW Classic and Outriders as new games, but mostly play old games on the side? Hey, you know what? If all you like is the old games, there's like so many there, you know? I think there's a lot of new games that are kind of doing the old game style too, so I think there's something for everyone out there. Oak and Hops, modern games can be great, especially indie titles. Agreed. Indie titles are the way to go. But development costs have gotten so crazy that many developers, publishers are afraid to innovate. You don't really have time to get into games now. Main reason why you watch Twitch. Yeah, can you believe it? I stream games and play games in my off time. Pando is a video game. Oh, Game Detective. I absolutely have played through the Atelier franchise. And I finally hunted down a copy of original Ryza. So I can get Ryza 2. But yeah, I've been playing the Altilia series since Iris back on the PS2. You got Persona 5 Royal this year. The battle system is real neat. You're just not a huge fan. Oh, Trickster Mix. I am so sorry to hear that, but I totally understand if Persona's not up anyone, some people's alley. It's very anime. But gosh, I love those Persona games so much. They're trying to bring back Dark Alliance, the new one, to live off the original, but you're scared that what it will bring to the table. I can see that, Mr. Bubbles. Game Detective, my favorite Altilia game is still just Iris. I've never enjoyed it more than Iris. Mount Colts is to the east. Okay, folks, just before we continue adventuring around the city, I do just need to take a quick bio break to the old washeroomino. So, hang tight. Talk amongst yourselves. Talk about your favorite indie games. I don't know. Talk about your favorite games. I don't know. I'm just going to be right back in two shakes of a Pika's tail. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. What on earth is happening here? This looks like it went sideways. So here we go. Back to the video game. Here we go. I just need to flip these around because this is in the wrong spot. Okay, great. Yeah. You declare shenanigans. Yes, clearly shenanigans has occurred. Mr. Bubbles, you try to keep your old titles, especially your Panzer Dragoon Saga title for Sega Saturn, which only 1,000 were released in the US dubbed. You have one of them. Nice. Panzer Dragoon Saga, who said anything happened, right, Captain Giraffe? Okay, Rod, enjoy playing games. Have a really great night. Thanks for joining us. I have a feeling over-emotional robot incited once again these shenanigans. Egg roll, buddy, it's been going really great. I honestly have been a little, I was a little spooked how everything would go here. But it's going great. I've been really enjoying it. This is, already a wonderful stream room.
Who's that Pokemon?
Hey, Mr. Bubbles, thank you so much for the sub. Holy, I really appreciate it. Holy bananas. Holy fiddle mix stickers. I could do this, right? Right, Math Mission said this earlier and I was like, what? Okay, I want one tent. I'll buy one of this. Yeah, check out these emotes flying around. Yeah. Okay, here we go. I think probably, so I don't have anything like Panzer Dragoon Saga in my collection. I do collect all, like, I do collect old RPGs myself. Though I have tried to limit, like, going out and buying old stuff I missed and the expensive stuff to only PlayStation 1 RPGs. However, so I think the rarest one I currently have in my collection is Suikoden 2. Or the Lunar games. Like, I have Lunar 1 and 2, both complete in box, in gorgeous, gorgeous sets. So, I'll have your finest one of this. Exactly. The best is the Saga one. It's the JRPG one. All the other ones are more shoot-em-ups. For Panzer Dragoon, that is. Yes. I actually have never played any of them, but I've seen them a lot. And yeah, the little spinning around, like, dragon shooter. That's what I've always assumed they all were, but once JRPG, like, I'm into that. My grandfather was a servant for the richest man in town. Well, isn't that nice? I'm off work. Get lost. I don't like strangers. Bring me some cider and maybe I'll talk to you. Ooh, bring you some cider and maybe you'll talk to me. Kid, get out of my way. I gotta bring this old man some cider. But first, we gotta check all these pots. I sometimes look at those pots and think they're like chamber pots. And I'm like, gosh, I hope not. He's easy. It wasn't well received, even though it was pretty good. Yeah, I've always heard good things about it.
Did you hear? Figaro Castle sank into the sand. You couldn't find it if you knew where to look.
Don't like strangers, but buy him a drink and he's your friend all night.
The house in the northern part of town belongs to our wealthiest citizen.
This town will go down fighting. Even with their Magitek armor, we'll make it tough on them.
Right, the Final Fantasy VI world should have plumbing, right? Not chamber pots? Oh, yeah, he talks too. Yeah, as you can see, so this is like one member of my stream team here. Oh, yes. We've requested to hear me, the Murloc buddy. So here you go. Here's words of wisdom from me, the Murloc. Thank you. Mwah. Mwah, mwah, you've been a wonderful audience. Thank you. Woo! So yeah, here, for folks who don't know, this is Morlock. He's part of the stream team. He sure can look panda face. And then, I know this is not Final Fantasy VI, but I've got my stream team buddies back here too. So we got Jiro, another Murloc, a Pichu, got a Wooloo, a Cactuar. Woohoo! This is a Chocobo actually right here. Here's kind of our mascot right here though. Cactuar's kind of hiding him tonight. But this is our Gamer Chew. We got Rexy here, and we got the Totoro. Yes, exactly, Mr. Bubbles. That's exactly who he is. From In's mouth? What does that mean? And Swiffer. We don't talk about Swiffer. Captain Giraffe. You love it. Yeah, I can't have pets, so I place plushies all around my place and pet them and call them my children. Oh, Call of Cthulhu. I see. My husband, Duncan, is a world-famous martial artist. He's taking his disciples to Mount Colts for meditation and training. To sit under some waterfalls, perhaps? Is where the fish people live. What makes me fish people like? My murlocs everywhere, probably? That makes sense. I just answered my own question, didn't I? I am more than a fish. I am more than a man. Death will rise from the tides. Ba-dum. You live in luxury apartments, and they only allow dogs, not cats or caged animals? That doesn't make any sense, Mr. Bubbles. Most of the places I've seen allow cats and no doggos. And you're right. All the luxury apartments that have been built around here all allow pets up the nose, but not so. My building is a really nice building. It's been around since the 70s, but it's been really well maintained, and that's what I really like about it. Plus, I have a very, very nice price. However, they just don't allow pets. It's like a bylaw here, and I'm like, meow. Number 9, don't you? Over emotional robot. Those bazongazoids. Well, I did not make them that big. It's true. Okay, here. I think I've inspected all around this town. So we probably have to go find our good friend. Okay, we got that tonic. All right, we want to try to get the juice first. Okay, here we go. Woohoo! A pando lost? Maybe. Okay, not really though. Okay, let's all go to A&W. Ba-bom, ba-food's more fun at A&W. Hop in the car. Come as you are to A&W. Seriously, your buddy's stuck in his rainbow boa and you've been buying a Hog Island boa soon because their rules suck. Apparently a big old snake was found in my city just sliding about, and people think that some previous pet owner just dropped him off and let him go in the wild, and that seems very sad for him. I want this. Can I get it? Can I get the... She's so... No upskirts, but... Can I not take it? Or do I have to beat this guy up? Right, Mr. Bubbles? Agreed. No, it's my job. I want to get it. Oh, okay, I'll do the cider thing later. Thanks, LaPanda Face. Deflagratio, you went to A&W after getting your first vaccine shot and they were out of root beer? Well, that's no good. What the bananas? Oh, I didn't realize this was here. Right? Defoglacio, are you also based out of... Are you in the U.S. or are you in, Canada?
This ship isn't going anywhere.
Shockwave, Rootbeer's pretty good, I agree. The biggest pets you had was a 5-foot Savannah monitor. Oh, so you do have an A&W around you. That's very interesting. In Canada, A&Ws are everywhere. They're almost as common as almost as common as McDonald's here, and they're totally different. They're owned by an entirely different corporation, even. So I always wonder when Americans reference A&W. The biggest pets you've had was a 5-foot Savannah monitor, bought a 6x4 tank for him, but let him roam around, and a 12-foot boa. They were your babies. That's so cool. I'm not afraid of snakes at all. I think that snakes and reptiles are really neat. I think I'm always just sad that they're not as cuddly as I want them to be. You've seen two A&Ws there. A combo A&W and Long John Silvers. That's so wild. Yeah, our A&Ws are, we have the burger family in our A&Ws, so you don't order a double cheeseburger. You open a, you order a mama burger, or a teen burger, or a grandpa burger, or a papa burger. I always get a mama burger with cheese. The only one that's not like a burger family member is the, is the matzah burger. Exactly. They wouldn't be, and they wouldn't bat an eyelash. It's a mama burger. Oh, that's so cool, Mr. Bubbles. I've heard that there's Defoglacio. I heard that there's like combo KFC, Taco Bell, and Pizza Hut. Like you can get Kentucky Huts. What's that smell? I don't like the sound of that. Please divorce the Mama Burger from the pickles. Okay, so whenever I order a burger, I get it plain there. Oh, I could sleep in his bed? Okay, that's weird. So I always order a plain mama with cheese. And this, his favorite tea. Yes, over emotional robot. That's Amanda, that's a panda order right there. Cookout is the greatest fast food restaurant ever. Chicken nuggets are aside and they have the greatest soda ever. Cheer wine. Defoglacio, we don't have Cookout. What's like Cookout's main thing? Really? Nice. People always think I am like a child, but that's how I like my burgers. Unless I'm having a more gourmet, like a fast food burger, I'll get it plain. But if I'm having something a bit more gourmet, I might put some other things on there. Mr. Bubbles, you live in the northeast of the U.S. and you don't have an A&W out here. What are they like? I think they're different in America than my A&Ws, but I don't know, Mr. Bubbles. These dishes, they were his favorite. Oh, we can just sleep in all the beds? Just excuse me while I sleep in every bed. I just think it's important, you know? Okay, cool. Cool. Okay, I read a fact. This has nothing to do with literally anything we were talking about. But I read a fact. Okay, I shouldn't keep sleeping in this bed. That an iPhone and a T-Rex are closer in time to each other, like 60 million years, than a T-Rex to a Stegosaurus, which was like 80 million years. And I'm not gonna lie to you. That blew my dang stinking mind, okay? Cookout's affordable burgers, 100 types of shakes, Cajun fries, and hush puppies. Captain Giraffe, you love the Teen Burger combo for $11 in 2006. It's like 17 for a combo now. I know, Captain Giraffe. All the stuff in... All fast food is so expensive in Canada now. It's like... I feel so poor here all the time. Oak and hops. Yeah, we definitely don't have... we don't have fried cheese curds at our A&W. That is bonkers, right, Le Panda Face? It blew my pando mind. Sabin, he was... here. I have never had a fried cheese curd, but that sounds bananas. Bananas. Your wife and you eat at Cookout for $14. I'm gonna be totally honest with you, Difficultio. I don't think I could go out with anyone in Canada and get food for under $14 for the two of us. Gotta get you a cousin burger, maybe a third cousin burger. With like a buffalo horseradish sauce for those excuse me while I cannot talk anymore. Mr. Bubbles, ooh, fried cheese curds. You've had them at top tier restaurants and that is great. With a buffalo horseradish sauce. Uncle Twice Removed burger. Seriously over emotional robot. You gotta look up the burger family. Fried cheese curds are delicious, but very heavy. Yeah, it sounds incredible. You could go for some poutine on tater tots. Now, Defilgratio, this Canadian here, I agree with everything you're talking about. I am crazy for poutine. What the? You know this guy? Of course! He left a couple of days ago after he heard Master Duncan was slain. He headed into the mountains. I heard Duncan's son, Vargas, is missing as well. I have a bad feeling about this. Stepmom Burger. They don't even advertise the Grandpa Burger anymore? It was just... man. Ugh. My flippin' country. Everything is like $80... Ugh, everything's just so expensive here. The best new kind of restaurants out here that are spreading is Life Alive, which specializes in vegan and vegetarian dishes, but tries to be the fast food of it. It's really good, though. I bet it is. That sounds really good. Honestly, the easier it would be to eat vegetarian, I would do it. Okay, so he went into the mountains because Sir Duncan died. Was slain, I mean. Let's save again. I might be, I don't know if I keep saving over the same spot over and over. Okay, let's, this must be where we're, whence we are going. Look at these look like, little, like, these grease monkeys look like they are, penguins, like the Batman villain. Right? They kind of do, right? Grease Monk is a good band name. I can see that, totally. Oh, I should have, oh, that's nice. Your town has all you can eat, made to order sushi. You win the restaurant wars. Oh, that sounds really good, Difficultio. Do you live near the ocean? Because it's really nice you can get that fresh seafood, right? You find yourself playing with a lot of people from the Manitoba area of Canada, especially in your guilds of WoW. It's weird. FYI, Canada is actually the land of Canada. Mr. Bubbles, as a Canadian, That's incredible to know. I had no idea. It was called Canadia. Actually, I think I call it Canadia all the time here. But that's fun that you play with a lot of Manitoba folks. I got a Manitoban here in chat. But myself, I live in Alberta. And I lived in Manitoba at one point of my life. Okay. That's good to know, Gurf. I will probably not try to steal if it's too rare. It's a coastal state. Well, then, Deflagratio, you have no problems. You will be able to... You probably have just really good sush then. But hey, you know where Manitoba is, which is very... Canadians love when you can name a province other than Ontario. Wow, these guys, I should probably have done my... I need to actually focus because I'm just going to get myself, dead like that. Okay, item, let's use a Phoenix Down. Unlock here. You're gonna use your tools here. Okay, you fight. You're now going to cure... Well, you're going to cure Locke after this battle. Mr. Bubbles, yeah, you live in coastal Massachusetts. And it's weird that you keep meeting people in Canada on the other side of North America. Hey, well, I mean... It's not really the other side. Manitoba's dead center. It's the center of Canada. There's actually a sign just outside Winnipeg saying... Welcome to the longitudinal center of Canada. Is it possible to already have it at the beginning of the game? Oh yeah, I don't mind you saying that at all, Shockwave. You have a Facebook friend from Calgary. Nice. Met a lot of peeps from Canada. Hey, Cruzy Life, thank you so much for following. Welcome to the Pando Party. Woo, 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 woo. Ding. Cactor pose. I can buy all of Edgar's stuff in his castle? Oh, okay. Well, well, well. Yeah, Calgary is my sister city. As in... They are the cities that are close together and highly competitive with each other. Okay, Terra. Magic. Cure. And yourself. Good night, LePandaface. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Rest well. Be safe. And maybe we'll see you tomorrow for Tuesday? TJ Duperman, how you doing tonight? Welcome back to the Pando Party. We spend money on the dumbest slogan ever. I bet. You know, Winnipeg, they need stuff going for them, right? Ooh, what's a guardian? Is it a relic? No, it's not. Is it just... What's a weapon for Locke? Perfect. Lock. Ooh, yes, that's a good weapon. Hello. Okay, fight. Fight. Tools. Yeah. It's great to hear, TJ Duperman. How was your weekend? Trickster Mix, it's a 6-year-old birthday gift. You almost went to Toronto to watch Kobe score his 81 points. Ooh, to go see a Raptors game. The first and only time I watched the NBA was to watch the Raptors win. It was really exciting. Hey, no worries. If you can only lurk, I always appreciate you being here. Oh, no worries at all, TJ Duperman. Please relax. Have a really great night. Enjoy lurking. Just have a good chill evening. Ooh, you see that shady character there? Quite literally. Fight. Tools, auto crossbow. Ooh, look at that. We went around the back of the mountain. So some... Ooh, look at these trilliums. I don't like them. They're just like vine monsters. Benny Ta... Oh, right. Aru. We're going to be poison... Okay. A moment of truth. I forget how poison works in this game. Is it persistent or is it per battle? Persistent, it looks like. Well, that's just Finnegan's and Frank's. Shockwave, Canada needs a win in the Stanley Cup, and living in Edmonton where the Oilers play, whenever we're even remotely close, you don't even know half of the excitement that goes on around here. Or when Canada's playing the gold medal game, yeah, the whole country just becomes, comes totally off the wall, nutso. Used to be Heart of the Continent, which made sense. Now it's Canada's Heart Beats. They actually paused and they mentioned it on the radio or TV. Oh, that's terrible, Captain Giraffe. I actually... really dislike that. Oh, you'll take damage every step. Okay, so good to know I have to deal with the antidote with the poison immediately. Oh, totally. If we need to. So, Mr. Bubbles, I usually try to play exactly how I would play if I was playing on my own, except I tried to keep it moving a little bit. But yes, if we need to do a grind, I will take time to do level grinding. And yeah, I think everyone here likes to watch all that stuff anyway. Level grind nights are good for me to just chitter chatter with chat, so... But I'll usually wait till, you know, we find we really need it. Exactly. I just grind and talk to you all. Exactly. Captain Jeff, I can see why you hate that. That is very bad. Shockwave, you have a sweet friend from Montreal who was born 4 years after the Habs won in 93. You would love her to see them win one in her lifetime. Yes. Taking damage every step in this game, yeah, that does seem like a definite nightmare. 100%. There we go. Dino Force is very dangerous, but there's some good stuff there. I like the sound of that for sure.
Who's that Pokemon?
Darkwing, thank you so much for the gift sub. I really appreciate it. Hey, Devil's Cry, what's going on? Can't forget grinding with Murky, it's true. How you doing tonight, Devil's Cry? The Brachiosaurus and Ultima suck. Wow, there's a dinosaur place here? That sounds incredibly exciting. I love dinosaurs. I want to fight some dinos. Well, actually, I want to befriend the dinos, but I just want to see the dinos. Oh. You're trying not to throw your PS4 through the TV. What are you playing, Devil's Cry, to make you so mad? You're on some serious hangry tonight. Uh-oh. Ouch. Oh, you've been having internet issues all weekend. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Oh. You have lots of recommendations on food. Captain Giraffe, anyway, does anyone have any exciting plans this week? Let me think. I'm gonna stream Pokemon tomorrow. And then I'll go back to streaming this on Wednesday. And then on Thursday, I will do nothing. And then Friday, I'll stream this. And then, yeah, you know, I'm going to be lying around and playing video games all week, so. Totally nothing at all, Captain Giraffe. Everything's par for the course here. For some reason, you can't get on PSN. Oh, man, that is no good. At least, hey, they reversed the decision on shutting down the PS3 and Vita stores for the moment, so. That's really nice. You have more time to buy those games as time goes on. Remodeling the lower cabinets in your kitchen. Deflagratio, that sounds like a fun thing to do, honestly. The dinosaurs, that is. Of course, Mr. Bubbles. You have to go get your apartment ready for tomorrow, Pando. Night, everyone. Good night, Trickster Mix. Relax. Be well. And, Trickster Mix, PS3... store has not been shut down for a while now. I actually still buy games there on the regular. So it's alive and well. And they actually reversed the decision to shut it down this summer. So it's very exciting. Shockwave, not much. You're getting snow. If I already said that, I'm so sorry. But that is fun. You can only buy through the PS3. So you cannot buy on your phone or anything anymore. You can only buy strictly on your PS3. But yes, you can buy games still on your PS3. It's still there. Because I bought something very recently on there. You're excited for the Pokemon, TJ? I'm excited for the Pokemon for us too. Mr. Bubbles, you got snow in the New England area last week. It is crazy after having 70 to 80 degree level weather. Well, it was just a... Hey, Char, how you doing tonight? It was a Circle of the Moon or Symphony of the Night, I mean. I think, gosh, maybe I was wrong, but I definitely go in there and wishlist stuff all the time. Yeah, well, it's still open, Trickster Mix, so I don't know what to... What's hip-hop happening for you? But yeah, no, Sony just announced they were shutting it down a few weeks ago, and now they've reversed it. So they're not shutting it down at all. Or for now, at least. Oakenhouse, maybe one day a PCPS store with countless retro RPGs. One day, right? Wouldn't that be great? Oh my gosh, here I am trying to do something. And, but yeah, I plan on buying Wild Arms on there soon. Why am I so Koopo for Koopo nuts? Okay. Yeah, you should Trickster Mix. It's true, Mr. Bubbles. I myself try to collect everything as officially as possible with the physical copies, but there are some games that are really only available on those PS1 classics on the PS3, so unless you want to drop the big money for them. Yeah, Mr. Bubbles, that's what this channel's all about, playing games that are blasts from the past. Hey, TJ Duperman, thank you so much for the gift sub. I super appreciate it. I don't know about that. I don't really love the new... I like the updated polygons in the 3D games, Mr. Bubbles, but I do not love the 2D ones. Yes, Eggroll Buddy. The PlayStation did reverse their decision. The PSP store, they determined they were going to close no matter what. But the Vita and PS3 store is remaining open for some time, which is very good. In my humble opinion. Because it gives me more time. Aha! A save point. Right, Oakenhops, I'm lucky enough that I own Suikoden. But yes, that's why I've told myself I'm only allowed to collect PS1 games. Hi, Star in Space, how you doing tonight? Hey, no worries, TJ Duperman. I really appreciate the thought either way. You wish they'd do a good new cinematic and graphical reboot of the original Final Fantasy games, though? That definitely could be interesting, I could see that. Eggroll Buddy, you're really hoping that this whole debacle changes their stance on backwards compatibility. This would not nearly be a big deal if PlayStation 1, 2, and Classics were available on the PS5. Yeah, I don't know. With Jim Ryan leading PlayStation, I still highly doubt that's going to happen. I think he's very stubborn and does not believe in old games. But it would be really nice if that was the case, wouldn't it be? Steal, no, fight. You've been better. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Star in Space. Is this my first playthrough? So I've played through, I made it like not very far back when I played it on the PlayStation 1 when my, I can't, sorry, I need a drink of water here. On the Final Fantasy Anthology for the PlayStation 1, I played it through to a certain point, not very far. And then I played it again on my Game Boy Advance, where I got the farthest I ever have, which is where Terra goes Koopo for Koopo nuts. But I stopped there. I got lost and kind of forgot about it. So this will be my first time beating the game for sure. Wish PlayStation would just develop an official PlayStation 1, 2, 3 emulator and sell old games to a dedicated emulator store. We'll probably print money over the years. Yeah. Real talk. Video game preservation is a real issue. It really is over Emotional Robot and one that I particularly am very passionate about. If you like old game stuff, I highly recommend the Video Game History Hour by the Video Game History Foundation. They have such interesting stories about game preservation, old game development. It's just really good stuff. Um, It's a shame it got to that point. It's true. Hello, Dennis. Oh, wah, wah. You're funny, Dennis. But in case you're serious, Final Fantasy VI was released as 3 in North America back in the old days. And then, Who doesn't love the cantina? I love. Now this is gonna be stuck in my head all day. Do 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 do. Right. Thank you so much for those bits in the cantina song. So I'm a casual Star Wars fan. I like Star Wars well enough. I think it's a funny series. Oh, we're poisoned. We poisoned. I think, you know, like everybody else, I like the very original movies a lot. I've always just loved the creatures and the aliens, and I love the cantina music. Do 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 do. Yeah, 4 did come over here as 2. That's true. Oh man. Poisoned again. I own the real Final Fantasy III on my DS when that's how they released it here. I never got very far, but that was back when I just played through a bunch of everything. Nowadays, I try to play everything through to completion before starting something else. Man, these antidotes are gonna go through us, aren't they? We're gonna go through these antidotes like they're going out of business. Yes, sorry. Oops, wrong button. I'm pressing too many buttons. Stop it. Let's go, Tara. Oh, you did the 2-player option, Mr. Bubbles? That's so fun. That's just real heartwarming. Gurf, you remember saving up $120 to get this game back then? Had to special order it from a Zeller's. Flip. Not Zeller's, right? Right, we are going through these antidotes like Pez candy. And TJ Duperman, I have not played through Divinity Original Sin 2, but I'd love to one day. It's been on my wish list for years. Skills. Double cast? How do you double cast? What do you mean? Okay, skills. Oh, wait, no. Item. Antidote. Oh, no. I should have bought some star pendants. What was I thinking? Oh, if you press RL on your spell targeting, you multi-target. Ow. It's like R1 or something. Well, shuck my corn. So true story, you just found out that Lunith in the Final Fantasy III remake is meant to be a male? Like, I always thought they were a female. Gosh, I know, like, next to nothing about Final Fantasy III, despite the fact that I played it a little bit. Yeah, they did eventually release all the games and their actual names now, too. I think you could buy Final Fantasies 1 to all of them as their actual numbered game now. Oh, gosh. Fight. I'm forgetting what I'm doing. I can't keep my act together. On Steam too, it's true. Heck, if you have Game Pass on your Xbox or PC, I think there's a ton of Final Fantasy games for... I was gonna say for free, but I guess it's as free as a Netflix movie is, right? So... Which, Game Pass, very cool. Very cool service if you like to play a lot of indie games and, you know, old games too. Magic. Let's, oh gosh. Oh, right. You have the antidote power. Oh, good. Do that, please. Just gaining levels like it's going out of style over here. Oh, I see you down there. Where did you come from? Should I go? Is that where I came out of? Oh no, it's where I'm going to. Okay. Ugh, the trilliums. Get them out of my life. Left, right, left. Sabin sent you, right? Another streamer was saying how the tents change color in one of the games. I think it's the one where you change classes. Down, diagonal, left, and right. The NES version is very difficult. Mr. Bubbles, are you telling me, like, the codes for the, like, how to do the... who are you? Sabin, is he here? You were shadowing us earlier, right? Brilliant! And how unlucky it is that you have run into me! Oh gosh, these bears. Okay. Magic, you're gonna cure already. Tools, you're gonna auto crossbow. I sure will be TJ Duperman. Fight. Magic, can you do fire? Oh no. On everyone, but you're... Oh, wait. That's not what I wanted to do. Okay, let's just cure again. Why not? Oh, wait. We're not hurting enough. Let's do this. Tools, do this. Fight. Yeah. Slash that guy. Let's get rid of these bears. Okay. Fight. No magic. Use a cure now. Perfect. Fight. He has the right to bear arms. Oh my gosh, that's so good. You didn't know Vargas is like 15 feet tall, right? I love the oversized sprites for the enemy bosses. No worries, Han Salami. Thank you so much for the lurk. I really appreciate it. He is beefy, right? He's a beefy dude. He's a beefy guy. Enough! Off with you now! Steal! What's the blitz? Give it up, Vargas! Is that you, Subin? Vargas, why'd you do it? How could you do your own father in like that? Fool! He made the mistake of choosing you as his successor. He snubbed me, his only son. No, you were the one he chose. You're a liar. Our master wanted you to be his successor, not me. He appreciated your fine spirit. Enough of your lies. Now have a taste of my superior technique. Mortal attack, blizzard fist. Uh-oh. Ah, Sabin. The master taught you well. I guess there's no avoiding this.
Fate made us train together, and fate will send you to your doom.
Truly a tragic turn of events here. Oh, what was I supposed to do? you said left, right, left? Oh, how do I do it? Left, right, left. Oh, I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Oh, wait, I think I know. I'm doing left trigger, right trigger. But here we go. Left, right, left. Oh, I must have... I don't know what I'm supposed to do that. I'm really failing. Okay, I'm gonna try one last time and then, oh, okay, never mind. Yeah. Okay. I'll try one more time. Left, right, left. Okay, it's not working for me. I don't know how to do it. Yeah, that's what I was doing. It's super not happening, though. Well, that's okay. We'll just get back there. Ah, well. Just like your original run. Hey, it ain't no thing. Sometimes it be like that, it's true. Hey, thank you so much for the bits. I don't know why I couldn't make it go. Okay, I'm gonna try next time. We're gonna make it happen. I'm gonna be able to do it. Didn't realize you had to input it. So I press blitz and just go left, right, left and be done with it. Like I don't have to wait. If there's like an attack going or whatever, just ignore it, just keep. Just go blitz, left, right, left. Blitz, left, right, left. No, I'm using a... I'm playing on the SNES Classic. Thanks, Char! Yes, the old SNES classic. So I go left, right, left, and then A? After I hit blitz, of course. After I hit, okay. Well, we got this time. I believe in us. In me. Yeah, you know, I think, I don't know how hard they are to find anymore. I know they can't probably buy them from the store, but... I do like them a lot. After I hit Blitz. TJ Duku... Hey, Duperman, if you enjoy hanging out here, lurking or not, I'm always happy. Okay. Antidote. Yes, I'm playing on a SNES Classic. Mothy, thank you so much for the bits. Very true. Final Fantasy VI is amazing, Shockwave. You're very right. I don't feel any certain way about a modded... honestly, if people mod and do whatever they want with their consoles, that's fine. I totally understand the reasoning behind it and all that kind of stuff. It's fun to turn it into a little Raspberry Pi, right? For me, I usually don't mess around with that stuff a lot. Although, I did buy a PS1 Classic, and because I think that they were so bad, I did get that one modded and threw a whole bunch of ROMs on there. Though, because you don't get a DualShock with it, I find it very hard to play those games without a DualShock. I need that analog, you know? Okay. Skills, Terra. Here we go. With such passion. Okay, I'm gonna go blitz, left, right, left, and A. That's what I will do, okay? Yeah, Sony tried to do a PS1 Classic and they... Wow, it was so abysmal. They are hard to find. Okay, here we go. Okay, we saw all this before. Sabin Senshu. Who are you? They really did aggro, buddy. They super dropped the ball on the PS1 Classic. Yes. It's the very small one. It's that, you know, the trend of the mini consoles, right? Okay, one bear down. Oh dear. Item. Phoenix down on Terra. Come on, what's the matter? Really? You're gonna do that to me? That's just rude. I need that Phoenix down. Okay, here we go. Sorry, just catching up chat. Is the Classic the really small one? Used to own one. You remember it being okay. TJ Duperman, I think you're thinking of the PS1 one, like the actual PlayStation 1 consoles. I'm talking about the mini console. Like it's like they re-released it like they did the Super Nintendo Mini, the Super Nintendo Classic. They also did a PS1 Classic. So it's like the really, like the one with just like a whole bunch of preloaded games and the tiny little console. And it's not, it wasn't a good version of one of those. You got one and released and modded it? Yeah. So you think if anybody can do a mini, right? It'd be Sony, right? But they dropped the ball so hard. Yeah, it's so true. They would have such a good library to do, but they just didn't even do it right. Yeah, it's because TG Duperman, it didn't have very good fanfare. People ended up not loving it at all. Okay, there we go. It's true. It's what happens when you're top dog. Like, we saw this exact same thing with the Xbox One, right? Where you're coming out of the 360 era, Xbox is the top of the food chain. They're like, we can do no wrong, so here's a whole bunch of stuff that's going to make gamers mad, but it doesn't matter because we're the best. And everyone's like, no thank you. And then they flipped over to Sony, and so Sony had a wonderful PS4, and now they're at the top of the food chain again. They're like, ha ha ha, no one can be mad at us, though they're currently having a very successful PS5, so... Right, Mr. Bubbles? Yeah. Yeah, you know, everyone... CEOs at giant corporations say the darndest things sometimes. I mean, heck, Nintendo previously said that mobile games, like, they would never sell games for $1 on their platforms because they thought that that whole model was worthless. And now look at the Switch shop and look at their own mobile offerings, right? Like, everyone has totally Koopo for Koopo Nuts ideas and all this stuff, right? Okay, here we go. Blitz, left, right, left, A. Oh, okay, I'm gonna just go left, right, left this time. Okay. I don't know what I'm feeling. Absolutely over emotional robot. That's totally what I would like to do. I'm just gonna fight him because I'm failing so hard at Blitz right now. You have to press A to finalize it. That's what I did, but I don't really understand. I did that already once, and it just, that also didn't work. So, I'm deeply concerned. Though I hope I have enough time to now, fight this guy before the doom is up.
Time to put an end to this. The master's teachings. Must use a blitz technique. Choose blitz. Press the control pad left, right, left. Then press the A button.
Okay. Okay, how to use blitz. Choose blitz and press the A button. Got it. When the cursor appears, enter your technique. Using the control pad, press left, right, and left again. Finally, press the A button to engage the attack. Yeah. If you make a mistake, nothing will happen. Relax, there's no need to hurry. Okay. Choose Blitz. Press the control pad left, right, left, then press A. Okay, great. They sure do. They really knock it into my head, don't they? Ah, there we go. We got it.
What the? He already taught you that?
There we go. Yeah, we got it. We figured it out, everyone. Here's my chance. Did you see when they announced that, how people reacted? Like, you think they knew. Could I get up on stage and hype something you legit had no faith in? You're not trying to, like, put you in some weird spot right now. Just genuinely curious. I think it was for my job, and I think I could convince people to like it. Usually those kind of announcements, though, aren't really done by marketing departments. Those kind of announcements are done by CEOs. So, I think I could do that. I mean, if I got a job, like, representing a game, it might not even be a game I'm super passionate about, But I think I could get people excited about it, you know? I don't know. You guess in the non-steam version you had to wait for them to tell you to do it? Ah, there it is. Right? I guess for a first time game you're like, what the F about this battle way back when?
If only you hadn't been
in such a rush for power. Goodbye, Vargas.
Sub in!
Big brother? The brothers are reunited! Younger brother? At first glance, I thought he was some bodybuilder who had strayed from his gym.
Bodybuilder?
I'll take that as a compliment. Anyway, brother, what are you doing here?
We are on the way to the Sibyl Mountains.
To the Returner hideout, no doubt?
Yeah, easy, first try.
You always had problems finding the cursor. I can see that, Dennis. I totally get that. Yeah, you thought about that a lot over Emotional Robot, especially watching game announcements. Yeah, honestly, I would just be so excited to be up there and, like, talking about games that it wouldn't really matter to me what I was talking about. I'd just be like, yeah, games, right, everybody?
I've been watching from afar, hoping that the world might regain some sanity. At this rate, Figaro will be reduced to a puppet state.
Our time to strike back has arrived. The Empire is going to pay for what it has done.
Think a bear like me could help you in your fight?
You'd join us?
Sabin! Yeah. I think Duncan would rest easier if he knew his disciple played a part in bringing a peace to the world. Right, April buddy? Are there any games I want to play but can't find because it's older and not sold anymore? No, not really, TJ Duperman, because I feel like I could acquire anything if I set my mind to it. There's a ton of games out there that I just don't own the physical copies of that I just sat on for a really long time because I just haven't got the physical copy of the game. But honestly, I do think that if I couldn't find something, I could find it, you know? Hey, TRZ, what's going on? Let's get going. Oh, Legend of Dragoon was the fifth game I ever played on stream, actually. I played and beat Legend of Dragoon from start to finish. TRZ, do you need a Final Fantasy IX command that says, Final Fantasy IX is the greatest game ever? Okay, we got a tent, very important. I thought you were one of Vargas's bears. Oh, that's such a good line there, Gurf. I would like that a lot, for sure. Okay, fight. Fight. Tools, auto crossbow. That could be a really fun thing to do, egg roll buddy. I am considering, like, I do need to have a nice, I do, like, at the bottom of the screen have a list of all the games I've played up to this point, but it's gonna get real long, so I should probably, like, get a Google Docs going and sort out the games I've played and, put them up there for everyone to see, and also maybe have all the games I own. That'd be kind of fun, right? Right, TRZ? Good night, Char. Have a really great night. Thank you so much for tuning in. Okay, we made it out of there. Let's save the game. We got our third member. Our fourth member, I mean? Third member. What is this? What am I talking about? See, the screen kind of warbles a little bit, like a wavy look. What's up with that? Oh my gosh, look at those guys, the Rodoks. They're so cute. They're like raccoon squirrels. I love them. Sorry that they had to die. So I imagine this is where I'm going, right? What's up here? Okay, nothing. Right? I was so cheery. Well, you know, they're here trying to murder me, so the Rodoks have to go, you know what I'm saying? Pando, everyone knows, Final Fantasy IX, best RPG. I'm glad I can contribute to the water spitting going around. Final Fantasy VIII, still my favorite, but that will probably just always be my favorite just because pure, full-blown nostalgia reasons, you know? Like, case closed. What's going on here? Okay, so we have another... Okay, so this is probably another dungeon, right? So I think that... I think that for all intents and purposes, this will probably be a really great place for us to wrap it up for tonight. So normally, for folks who don't know, I normally stream 7 to 11 my time, which would be 6 to... 10, well, it's 6 to 10 Pacific time or 9 to midnight Eastern time. No, 9 to 1 Eastern time? Anyway, I always start my streams at 7 Mountain time, which is 6 Pacific or 9 Eastern. So, I will be back on Wednesday with more Final Fantasy VI. So, please tune in for that. And if you like what you saw and you want to follow, please throw the panda a follow. Tomorrow night, however... Hey, RyanO1124, thank you so much for following. Welcome to the panda party. Woo, 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 woo. Ding, cactuar pose. Tomorrow is a special bonus day of... Tuesday. So I'll be playing more Pokemon on Tuesday.
Good night. See you again sometime.
Yes. See you again, Mr. Bubbles. Thank you for following and for those gift subs. I so appreciate that. I will be here tomorrow for a bonus stream, which is Pokemon Tuesdays. So if that sounds fun, join us for that. But for more Final Fantasy VI and more Season 12, Episode 2, which will be Wednesday, 7 p.m., where we'll play more Final Fantasy VI, which is really great. Komodo, hello. I hope you're doing really great tonight. Join our Discord if you want to have a say on what the Pando plays after Final Fantasy VI. I know TRZ would vote Final Fantasy IX again, but that was not very long ago that we played it. Thank you, Darkwing. I'm going to be posting a poll, though, for what Season 13 should be so that we can know that ahead of time. I'm going to put Sega Frontier Remaster up there that just came out on the Switch. So that could be a really good one. Yeah, voting. Thank you so much, Eggroll Buddy, for hanging out with us. So let me just see who we can go and Raideroo. Let's go to the old Twitcheroo here and B is on. Yeah, let's go raid B. She's playing that Final Fantasy. She's playing that Vagrant story and she's just the best. So here we go. Everyone vote for the games you like, please. You can go into that vote channel and do a whole giant campaign for the games you want, my friend. Okay, everyone, have a great night. Thanks for joining us. Bye.